football starts tonight for North Haven High School with three games left to go. Mike Vanacore Field, it is the North Haven Nighthawks squaring off against the Xavier Falcons. Michael Valenti alongside Trevor Keys. Big game here starts tonight.
Yes, sir.
You got the Xavier Falcons. They started the season 0-3, but they've won the last four games.
I'll go even better. They went 0-4. They started 0-4, but they're on a three-game winning streak right now. They're doing a lot with their quarterback. Another big, strong-armed quarterback can make plays. We just saw last week what Nick Conlin can do, being the dual-threat guy. Now it's Sam Andrea. Can North Haven be able to get to the quarterback? That's the most important thing. When you have a quarterback that can throw the ball, extend plays, you got to make his night uncomfortable. But we were just talking right before we're going live. It's starting to get a little windy. How does that play into Xavier's game plan? And you know what that's going to do for North Haven. Ground and pound.
There was a little bit of a win last week against West Haven, and that didn't really bother West Haven at all. They also did a lot of running.
But you didn't see them throw
on the ground.
You didn't see them throw the ball a lot as much. You saw a little short throws. You never saw them over the top. But yeah, Michael, 450 yards rushing on the ground by the Blue Devils between Nick Conlin and Corian Harris. So North Haven's going to have their hands full tonight. They have to get after this backfield. Can they get after the quarterback? Huge game, you just said it. Playoff, we can't be thinking playoffs, but yes, the season is coming down to the wire. Three games left. Game before Thanksgiving, or I should say the last home game before Thanksgiving. North Haven has really have their hands full. It's going to be an interesting matchup. Another SEC, great matchup. And me, as an SEC guy, I love seeing matchups like this.
Now, we bring up the playoffs, and obviously, here on out, it's win or go home.
Yeah.
Because they're the 8th seed right now,
yeah.
And there's a lot of teams right there in the mix. So yeah. If North Haven loses, they're gonna have trouble.
They got to just play the game. To answer the question, they just got to play their game. Run the football, get Artie McCormick heavily involved. Joe Mastriani, heck of a game last week. Probably his best game of the season that we both saw, really running hard. And I want to see some more passing. But like you said, Michael, the time is ticking. Not much left in the season. Can North Haven finally get their identity? I've been talking to a lot of people during pregame. Can North Haven find their identity? They don't have an identity yet. Well, it's a perfect time to do it with less than a month left in the season.
Yes, and you brought up Artie McCormick. Good news. Last week he left the game with an ankle injury. He is dressed. He is ready to play. But the question is, how much would he be used tonight knowing that injury is going to be there?
Well, from what I've heard, he's good. He's good to go. There's no any problems, no setbacks. Pre-game, he looked good. He's ready to go. I'm feeding him the ball. Last week, they kind of used him in a more of a decoy role. But this week, he's gotten you there into a sense of you found your guy. You got your identity with that, your go-to guy. Get him the ball. You saw what he can do against East Harvard. Was having a 300-yard performance. You know that he's a special talent. If you could get him and Mastriani, Curtella, DeMoro, and Stevens as well, all involved, I keep harping on it, this offense can really do some damage if they get all of them going and just get that identity, which we know is running the football.
Yes, it is. And they'll definitely have to run the ball tonight to get, you know, control that clock and have a big advantage into this game. And it's going to be a tough one, you know. Both teams really need to win on out just to have postseason hopes alive. And it's going to be a fun one here.
It's getting windy, Michael.
We'll take a quick break. When we come back, kickoff here at Mike Vanacore Field. You're watching Friday Night Football on NHTV.
The Rotary Club of North Haven, where the business community comes together. For personal growth and leadership development, Rotary makes one a better community citizen. For more information, please visit nhrotary.org today. Arnold's Jewelers, the North Haven Diamond Center, 117 Washington Avenue in North Haven. Decades of experience and a deep commitment to the North Haven community. Visit us today at thearnoldsjewelers.net.
Just awaiting kickoff here at Mike Vanacore Field. Michael Valenti alongside Trevor Keys as the North Haven Nighthawks are heading into the end zone, as you see right there, getting some last-minute motivation before this big game. As I mentioned before the break, it is postseason playoff for the Nighthawks already, as they have to win on out just to have a chance at the playoffs. Right now, they come into this game the 8th seed in the Class M playoffs bracket. And Xavier, you know, they're a team that started slow, but they've gotten themselves in a winning streak here as we're just a couple minutes away from kickoff and heading into the coin toss here. So we see the captains heading to midfield here, Trev.
Yeah, I mean, here we go. It's another beautiful Friday night. I mean, think about it. We're coming into, what is it, seventh game of the year, and still 60 degrees, a little windy, a little colder, but I mean, the weather has been perfect. As any football fan, you couldn't have asked for better weather. But North Haven, right from the get-go, really have to be aggressive. They really can't be having no penalties. Or in a situation for Xavier, the best thing I can say for them, you want to get North Haven in second and longs, third and longs, where they don't want to be throwing the ball. If North Haven gets comfortable where they're running second and fours, third and shorts, it's going to be a long night for the Falcons.
North Haven won the toss, but they deferred, so they will kick it off, and Xavier will start with the ball. And as I noticed with the kickoff there, the captains, Mark Sadak of Xavier, in his casual clothing, he will not be playing in this game today.
It could be a big loss for the Falcons. But like they said, when you have a good quarterback like Andrea, as an opportunity that can really extend plays, make a lot of big plays for this Falcons offense. He's kind of like their do-it-all guy once again. And for North Haven, linebackers are going to have to be crucial tonight. I was watching a lot of film with this offense. Quick throws, a lot of middle of the field, tight end. You're seeing a lot of motion. You're allowed to see crossing routes. Got to be able to watch your zone. Stay in your zones. Wherever they go, make sure you're having an eye on each and every player for this North Haven defense.
Mike Vanacore Field for the second to last home game of the season for the Nighthawks as they square off against the Xavier Falcons. Again, Michael Valenti alongside Trevor Keys for this huge, huge matchup in the SEC division. And both teams fighting for playoff position. North Haven right now sitting at that eighth seed. They'll start.
Backfield, Bryson Smith. So North Haven's going to have their hands full. This defense specifically.
Opening kickoff goes into the end zone from the foot of Eli Reynolds for the touchback. And North Haven will be defending starting at the 20-yard line here with the Xavier Falcons, as you mentioned, led by quarterback Samuel Andrea and Ian Pringle at running back. Xavier will go in shotgun formation, as we see a lot of times against the North Haven defense. It's a lot of shotgun formation. And it'll be a handoff the middle. And that would be Pringle getting to the 25-yard line for a gain of 5.
And you know that Xavier watched the game from last week's game against West Haven. They're going to try to exploit that front seven of North Haven. And right off the bat, you see a nice run, 4 or 5 yards for Xavier. So kind of the start you want to see with this rushing attack. And North Haven got to be aggressive tonight. Got to make tackles as well, I should say. A lot of broken tackles we've seen in the past couple weeks.
Second and 4 is actually the down and distance. Pringle gets it again, and this time North Haven clogs it up. Maybe a yard on that one, but not much after that.
And that's what they're going to have to do. These are big backs in the backfield, Michael, so you're going to have to be the lower man, and hopefully you got your teammates behind there like you just saw, as we used to call them, the tribe, the North Haven tribe, but the Nighthawks, all of them, right there making the big play. And now North Haven, or Xavier, I should say, third and short, keep an eye on number 7 in that backfield. He will move if he has to.
Pringle lines up to the left side here on third down. Dropping back, Andrea throws wide open up the middle, and that's going to be a complete for the first down to Connor Gallarini For the first down.
Is that the tight end? Receiver, tight end?
No, it's a halfback, listen.
But like I did say, they like to look in the middle of the field. A lot of the throws are crossing routes, underneath routes. They might not. They'll try to catch you off guard with throwing over the top, but a lot of the throws have been underneath routes. And right there, you just saw a little soft zone and Andrea with a nice throw.
Hand off again. Pringle gets pushed outside. The clock will continue to run, though, as the ball goes near the 40-yard line. Actually, Beckett Fuller, I believe, was the one that pushed him out of bounds there.
Beckett Fuller, with help from Johnny Wilson.
And this Xavier team, they were 7-3 last year, made the playoffs, so they have it also a returning entire offensive line, so that can play a huge factor against an inexperienced defensive line of North Haven. So let's see how that battle plays out for this rest of the game.
Pringle goes up the middle to no avail, maybe a couple yards, but that's about it. Crossing the 40-yard line. So it'll be third and borderline manageable there.
He's trying to figure out third and nine. We'll make it, like I said, it's third and manageable. This is where Xavier wants to be in a situation. Another third down. If North Haven, where do they do right here? Do they come off the edge with a blitz, try to get Andrea to make an uncomfortable throw he doesn't want to, and especially that middle of the field where we just saw the first down for Xavier early on in this drive.
Andrea drops back, looks to throw, and he's going to be sacked behind the line of scrimmage. Joey Mastriani, I believe, was part of there. Also, Brian Moran being involved on that sack. Huge sack there. Forces fourth down.
Amen to that, Michael. A huge sack for the Nighthawks right there. He was looking again, same kind of concept, underneath route to number nine, his running back where he got the last time they converted on the first down. But North Haven right there. One of the few sacks I've seen recently from North Haven's D-line, but a heck of a drive for this defense and kind of a situation where you want to have, if you're North Haven, a confidence builder, I should say.
Roll out of bounds.
That one rolls out of bounds, so North Haven will start just shy of the 45-yard line. So good field position for them on their first possession of the game with 8:39 to go in the first. First and 10, ball officially marked at the 44-yard line. North Haven with their single-wing offense. And this one will be direct up the middle, crossing the 45.
It's right up the middle.
Close to the 50. And that was Joey Mastriani, who had a big game against West Haven last week with the carry.
Yeah, I want to see how he branches off of last week's game, where he really, really impressed me. Tough, hard-nosed run. Every run, it felt like he was just trying to get as many positive yards for North Haven and really showed that fight, where especially last week when they had McCormick as the decoy. Mastriani really took hold of this offense last week, so does he kind of have that jolt coming off of last week's performance?
Second and 6. Ball gets behind him and diving on it just before the defender gets there. That's Artie McCormick botching that one there. And this one, that one is on McCormick, I think.
Just slipped right through his hands, Michael. Just as basic as you could get, right through the hands. And luckily, McCormick recovers it for North Haven. And now, this is where Xavier wants to be. They want to be in a third and long situation against North Haven, where North Haven is an obvious passing down situation for them.
Third and long. Joey Mastriani, who we know throws on the throwing downs, is in behind center. He gets the snap. He'll take it himself and roll out. And lower his shoulder, but shy of the 50-yard line and well shy of the first down marker. So North Haven on their first possession go 3 and out.
It looked like there might have been some positivity, but sometimes you have those faults where you see a penalty kind of set you back. In this case, it's the fumble by McCormick. So how does North Haven come out back into defense after the nice, impressive first drive defensively, getting after Andrea and playing hard and making tackles on the big backs? So how do they continue to fight? That's what I want to see. Is there fight left in this North Haven Nighthawk team?
Evan DeMauro will be punting for North Haven to Dylan Gassner. Angled punt, pretty deep. But Gassner will return this one, and he's going to be stuck inside the five, but sneaks away and dropped at around the 15-yard line. So a little juking and jiving there gets him out of dangerous territory, but still some good field position for North Haven's favor on that one. Xavier around the 17-yard line looks like they'll be marked.
And that's a big thing. North Haven's going to have to do a good job at staying at home and not over-pursuing, whether it's on special teams or defensively, and they got to make the tackles.
6:35 to go here in the first quarter. No score yet. Both teams punt on their first possession. Only one first down on the first two possessions. That went to Xavier on a third and manageable. Man in motion. And this will be a handoff up the middle. And that is going to be Pringle on the carry, getting it past the 20-yard line.
Four-yard
carry.
Like I said, I really want to see how this defensive line gets after this offensive line, the experienced offensive line of the Falcons, getting in the backfield. You saw in the first drive, getting the sack and making plays in the backfield, stopping the runners. Can they do that again and feed off of their energy in the first drive?
It does go to Pringle. It looked like it was going to be a fake handoff, but a fumble on the ground. And let's see whether it's Mark. It is North Haven's football.
Sorry, Michael. I jumped the gun right there. I got a little excited. That's the football part of me. I see the ball on the ground. Free ball. Ball's on the ground. Got to get it. A huge, huge break for North Haven. They're going to have tremendous field position. And Xavier definitely doesn't want to be in a situation where they're having turnovers.
Yep. Pringle puts that one on the ground, so North Haven starts this one at the 24-yard line. It will be Mastriani, and next to him will be Tyler DeMoro on this first and 10. Shift goes from the right to the left. Mastriani takes the snap, goes to the left, finds a hole, gets to the second level, and is tackled there just shy of the 20-yard line.
Now, Michael, if you remember last week, we saw this situation where North Haven was in the red zone six times, capitalized once. Can North Haven, short field, can they capitalize in the great territory against Xavier, where last week they were moving the ball. They had a lot of confidence. They just couldn't put in the end zone. And can North Haven gain that confidence back offensively?
McCormick comes in for Mastriani on this second down and 7 from the 21-yard line. McCormick hands it off. Going up the middle, that was Chris Curtella. He's close to the first down marker, but will be just shy. So it'll be third and short for North Haven. And from what I'm seeing so far in these first two possessions, they're getting positive yardage in the running game.
Yeah, that's what North Haven wants to see. Oh, we got an injury player.
And an injury. Timeout. It looks like it's a North Haven player.
Injury timeout on the field.
So with 5:02 to go here in the first, we'll take our first timeout here. You're watching Friday Night Football on NHTV.
North Haven Funeral Home. 36 Washington Avenue, North Haven. Since 1953, the one source families rely on for caring, compassionate service. North Haven Funeral Home.
Rotary Club of North Haven, where the business community comes together for personal growth and leadership development. Rotary makes one a better community citizen. For more information, please visit nhrotary.org today.
Huh? 5:02 to go in the first quarter. No score here between the Nighthawks and the Falcons. And it's Nate Eggerling that comes off the field. He does appear to be limping off the field with Coach Sagnella there. So North Haven on a 3rd and 1 from the 15-yard line. And just before we came back from the break, Trev, you were saying that this is 4-down territory.
Absolutely. I mean, this is 3rd and short. North Haven's not going to be kicking the ball. But the way their offense is designed, 4th and short is right in their breadbasket. Or 3rd and short, this is where they want to be.
It'll be Mastriani taking the snap with DeMoro to his left. No, DeMoro takes the snap. And he's going to run around to the edge. Stiff arms a couple guys. Stays on The sideline is pushed out of bounds, and that's going to be a North Haven first down. So we don't typically hear DeMoro's name called, but he gets a big first down there.
But that's a huge deal because you just said it, Michael. We haven't really called his name a lot when carrying the ball. But, hey, if he can get involved in the offense, Coach Agnell is going to love it. Just another weapon to use in this offense. And I kind of thought, I didn't know if he was going to get it outside, bounce it outside. He did make the play, but I looked like I thought he could possibly cut in. Might have had probably maybe a touchdown right there. But, hey, DeMoro, we haven't really called his name in the backfield. He continues to get involved. It's a great thing for the Nighthawks.
McCormick has an open field to the left side, trying to get to the five, and he's tackled just shy of there. Nice tackle there by number 29, Vincent Rivera.
Rivera with a great open field tackle. It's basically one-on-one with McCormick and him, and Rivera made a heck of a tackle and stopping him from getting in the end zone.
So clock continues to run. 4:20 to go here in the first quarter. Second and six. From the 6-yard line.
Xavier's fighting right now. They are fighting, and they have kind of like the way North Haven plays, a bend, don't break defense as of right now.
So it'll be Mastriani and DeMoro. Mastriani takes it upon himself, goes up the middle between the tackles, and he dives into the end zone for the touchdown. The Nighthawks, who last week did not have the lead at all, strike first here this week against Xavier.
And if remember, last week, 1-for-6, their first drive in the red zone, 1-for-1. A heck of a start. What you want to see for North Haven, and they'll take it. I know Xavier, they give him the short field after the fumble with Pringle, but hey, North Haven's going to take it, and they're going to take advantage of it, and a nice drive, and you see it. McCormick getting involved. DeMoro, you heard his name get called. And then Joe Mastriani kind of branching off of what he did last week with another strong, hard-nosed run into the end zone. So a very, very good start from this Nighthawk team.
And the extra point is blocked.
Just when I say something good, something happens like this. We've seen a lot of this from whether it's North Haven or the opponents this year, where people are struggling in special teams, field goals. Not even just, we're talking extra points here. Struggling a lot this year around the state, it seems like.
3:57 to go. North Haven leads 6-0. You're watching Friday Night Football on NHTV.
Arnold's Jewelers, the North Haven Diamond Center, 117 Washington Avenue in North Haven. Decades of experience and a deep commitment to the North Haven community. Visit us today at thearnoldsjewelers.net.
North Haven Funeral Home, 36 Washington Avenue, North Haven. Since 1953, the one source families rely on for caring, compassionate service. North Haven Funeral Home.
So it's Joey Mastriani that gets it through the goal line, and North Haven with a 6-0 lead. Reynolds kicks this one off, and this one will be returned from the 10-yard line to the 20, to the 25, and tackled at the 28-yard line. Returned there by William Weber. Flag on the play on the return. It's around the 44-yard line. So away from the play. This could be a holding on the receiving team.
Yeah, most of the time when it comes to a flag, especially with special teams, usually it's going to be on the receiving team, I would assume.
Oh, this one's going to be on North Haven.
Interesting.
Seems like after the play, they might call like a personal foul, dead ball. It's on Xavier. So Xavier gets the penalty. So they're going to have to go back. Not sure what the personal foul was on.
I didn't really see anything that was noticeable.
Yeah.
Flag.
Yeah, I mean, Chris Doobie, the referee for tonight's game, originally looked like he went personal foul on North Haven.
Yeah.
But then changed his mind or didn't realize where he was pointing. So it'll be 1st and 10 from the 15-yard line after the penalty.
Sometimes I have that problem, my left and right. You know, it happens. Happens to the best of us, Mike.
Man in motion. Fakes the handoff. Andrea looks to throw. The pass is complete up the middle and goes to the 20-yard line. Tackle made by Artie McCormick.
And like I said, the first two throws by Andrea tonight have been in the middle of the field. And North Haven's going to have to start keeping an eye on that middle of the field. Or maybe that could help out Xavier in a situation where they do like to take the chance over the top. We'll see how North Haven plays. But right now, Xavier is in a situation where they don't want to be in. Deep into their own territory. How does North Haven keep going, feeding off of the touchdown by Joe Mastriani?
Andrea, another pass complete. This time goes to Dylan Gassner. The previous pass was to Justin Pringle. And with that, that's a Xavier first down. So back-to-back passes. And what I'm seeing early on here, it looks like Andrea is trying to find those passes between the tackles. And that's so far wide open. Well, all these receivers are going uncontested.
You saw a lot last week with Conlon. They didn't really, the two opportunities that we saw from Conlon last week of throwing over the top was a pick and almost another pick by the secondary of North Haven last week. But we saw a lot of out routes, deep in routes, and that's where Xavier's going to explode them. If they're playing soft, coverage on them, they're going to take advantage of it. And that's what they just did on the first couple plays with throwing the ball.
Andrea just makes it past the line of scrimmage, so it won't be a sack, but no gain on the play. Nice stop there by the defense. Second and 9 from the 33-yard line. No, I mean, North Haven's not really bringing any extra pressure, so good job by that defensive line getting to the quarterback on that play.
But sometimes you want to bring that pressure, especially with a 3-down front. You want to try, especially with a quarterback as well that can throw the ball like Andrea. You want to get some sort of pressure and make him uncomfortable throughout the night.
Andrea fakes the throw, gets it to the 35-yard line. And it'll be third and manageable for Xavier.
Well, he was looking for his first read, but his first read slipped, so he cut. Smart decision by Andrea to hold the ball, keep it, just take some sort of positivity right there instead of forcing anything and maybe causing more harm for the Falcon offense.
Third and 9 from the 30, or excuse me, third and 6 from the 36-yard line. And it will be two wide receivers on the far side, one on the near side with Pringle to Andrea's left. Under 30 seconds to go in this first quarter. Andrea fakes the handoff again. Brings pressure, and he's going to be sacked. Tyler DeMauro comes in uncontested with a big sack there, and that's going to force Xavier to punt.
What did I say, Michael? Bring some pressure. You see him disguised. It looks like he's coming in. Waits for the opportunity. 14, great job of going in there. And then you see DeMauro outside making the play, seeing where his defense, 14 coming in, taking that tackle out of the play. DeMauro coming in, and that's two sacks for the Nighthawks defense. And that's what I said. When you're aggressive, especially against a good quarterback, it's going to be a long night for him if you could get to him.
So North Haven will punt here. Or excuse me, Xavier will punt to North Haven. Good snap. Punt nearly blocked by McCormick. Fair catch made by Joey Mastriani. So North Haven starts just around midfield into Xavier territory. So 40 seconds into this first quarter, they're in great field position to add on to their 6-0 lead.
Yeah, I mean, if you're coaching now, obviously he's talking to one of his players. I calling the play into the huddle right now. But right now, defensively, getting after Andrea, really having, looks like he's been all over the field right now because of the two sacks. And then they're running the football. It seems like old North Haven, where they just are just putting away their nerves, just doing what they have to do, take care of business, and just kind of feed off of what they've been doing so far early on in this game.
First and 10 from the 49-yard line. Man in motion. It will be handed off to Chris Cretella, trying to get around the edge. Breaks through and tackled.
Gives up a couple of yards.
At the 47-yard line, and maybe they get one playoff before the end of the quarter.
Just shy of the 46, so it's going to be second and about 7.
Second and 7 from the 46 is the official down and distance. This looks like they'll line up for one more play before the end of the quarter.
I don't think they have to run another play, but might as well if they're ready to go.
They do snap it before the end of the quarter. It's Mastriani getting across the 45. It'll be third and manageable as we head into the second quarter. North Haven with the 6-0 lead after Joey Mastriani gets it into the end zone on their second drive of this game. You're watching Friday Night Football on NHTV.
The Rotary Rotary Club of North Haven, where the business community comes together. For personal growth and leadership development, Rotary makes one a better community citizen. For more information, please visit nhrotary.org today. Arnold's Jewelers, the North Haven Diamond Center, 117 Washington Avenue in North Haven. Decades of experience and a deep commitment to the North Haven community. Visit us today at thearnoldsjewelers.net.
We get set for the start of the second quarter. Michael Valenti alongside Trevor Keys here from Mike Vanacore Field. The Nighthawks currently with a 6-0 lead and into Xavier territory. Third and four from the 44-yard line. Would you start saying four down territory here,
right,
Trevor?
Here? Absolutely. Absolutely.
Easy answer, yes. Anything you see, if it's third and short like this, they're like,
after this play, I'll give my explanation, what they remind me of.
McCormick gets through the edge. He's got the first down, so we don't even need to worry about fourth down here, and it will go to the 35-yard line. So North Haven first down.
But you know, I was going to compare them in a situation where they're third and short. It's like the Eagles. Once the Eagles get into third and short, you know they're going to go for it because they have that quarterback sneak. In this situation, North Haven's running attack, 1 yard. That's basic for them. They go to sleep thinking about that. That's like in the Bible. That's the Holy Bible for them. 1 yard, 1 yard run. That's what they got to do. So it reminds me of watching the Eagles sometimes when it's third and short. But in a situation like what we just saw, we don't have to worry about fourth down, Michael.
First and 10 from the 35-yard line. North Haven trying to add on to their 6-0 lead. And it'll be Romano and Mastriani behind center. Mastriani trying to go to the outside. He's got room and is hit right there past the 30-yard line. So a gain of about 7 on the first down run there by Mastriani. And what we saw last week, we're starting to see this week from Mastriani.
He's starting to take what he was supposed to be coming into the season, being like that main guy. But now him and McCormick have really taken off for this offense. And you're starting to see the confidence of Joey Mastriani come back. Starting with last week, great, a heck of a performance. And like what Michael just said, it's carrying into this game.
Mastriani again behind center. Takes the snap, looks to throw this time. The pass is complete to an open receiver. First down, and that's another North Haven first down. That one completed to Brian Moran.
And a nice look at that. Nice little short throw. Got your guy in the flat. Throws it to 33. Nice play. Tries to keep going. But, hey, North Haven gaining more confidence with the passing game, running game. And now they're back in the red zone. Can they capitalize again like they did in the first drive?
Last week, 1-for-6 in the red zone. So far tonight, they're 1-for-1. Mastriani with DeMoro as the team shifts from left side to right side in the formation. Snap goes to Mastriani, hands it off to Cretella. Not much there on that carry on first down, but keeps the clock moving and the ball going in the positive direction.
Michael, this is like very slow tempo. They're really slowing this game down, trying to keep Xavier's offense off the field. Ground and pound, wear and tear, tire them out. One of the few stops you've seen from this Falcon front. So can they find a way to get back on offense and hold North Haven maybe to a field goal or maybe even nothing going forward in this drive?
McCormick is in on second down and 9. Takes a snap, runs to the near side, tries to get around the tackler, but he's tripped up right there by number 23, William Weber. And it's a third and long situation here for North Haven. No gain on the play for the freshman.
So if I'm North Haven, if you're thinking run, I'm trying to cut that down in distance to maybe half of where you can make it a fourth and manageable if you want, where you just saw a pass play, a couple plays previous, got a first down. Maybe you see something like that, something short where they can try to cut down on this third and 10.
So it is a passing down situation. We already saw Mastriani throw once in this possession. Will he throw again here on third down? He rolls out, looks to throw. Is going to be stuck, evades one sack, but he's not going to evade the second sack, and he's going to be dropped for fourth down there. And the sack made by number 36,
and looks like he's
Bryson
trying,
Smith.
He's trying to get his guy out there. No, everybody covered. Great job. He tries to extend the play. Maybe if he breaks that tackle, could be Painter. But a heck of a play by the Falcon front, getting a sack and a much-needed sack in a situation where what does North Haven do now? Where it's fourth and long, You're still inside about the third, inside the 30. What does Coach Sags do in this situation?
North Haven calls the timeout with 8:39 to go. You're watching Friday Night Football on NHTV.
North Haven Funeral Home, 36 Washington Avenue, North Haven. Since 1953, the one source families rely on for caring, compassionate service. North Haven Funeral Home.
The Rotary Club of North Haven, where the business community comes together. For personal growth and leadership development, Rotary makes one a better community citizen. For more information, please visit nhrotary.org today.
So fourth and 20 from the 27-yard line. North Haven will go for it. And this is a team that we know runs about 99.7% of the time.
He didn't say 99.9.
They've been throwing more this year. Mastriani looks to throw. He throws this one deep, and it will be gone. Complete. He had him in his hands. Cretella had it in his hands, but maybe a little underthrown.
No, that looked like a good throw. Mastriani, nice throw. I'm surprised. Referee saw a little push off by the North Haven player right there. Surprised that maybe they wouldn't call it, but a huge break for this Falcons defense where they could get back on offense now and try to get back to what they want to do, passing the ball, short passes, and running it with Pringle and Bryson Smith.
So the failed fourth down attempt makes it 1-for-2 on the red zone in this game. North Haven still with the lead, 8:34 to go here. We saw Andrea and the Xavier offense start moving the ball forward in the passing game.
Yep.
And this time they start first and 10 with Pringle. Breaks a couple tackles and then dropped at the 33-yard line.
He's a big back. You're going to have to go lower on him in this case. If you want to go head-on with him, it's like going against Derrick Henry. Most of the time, results are not going to be in your favor. But that's what North Haven's got to do. They got to be the lower team, got to get after him and go for the knees if you have to. In a situation like that with a big back, that's the only way you can if you're a smaller defender.
Pass is intercepted, and this one's going to come back. That's Brandon Stevens to the 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown, Nighthawks!
And just when Xavier thinks that they could get some confidence on this offense, it's just a demoralizing play for this team. Look at this. Great coverage by North Haven. Staying at home. Andrea looking for his slot, looking for the deep out. But a great job of Stevens coming in and just jumping the route. And a heck of a play. Cutting back inside. Seeing he knew he might have not made that touchdown. But a great job. The great vision. And a heck of a play by this Nighthawk defense. I think, I don't know if that's the first pick six of the year at home, but it was a heck of a play and a much-needed play for this North Haven defense to kind of gain that confidence back.
7:53 to go. North Haven adds on after the pick six by Brandon Stevens, and that is, I believe, the first pick six at home this year for North Haven. They had a few last year on their second Class Double M state championship run. And North Haven's going to go for two here. Mastriani looks to throw. Has a man open. Throws to his left, and it is complete. They get the extra point, the two-point conversion. Anthony Perillo gets the two-pointer.
Looks like he's going to the deep corner. Had a guy wide open there, but he set the throwback. A heck of a job right there. I like the creativity by Coach Zags on the two-point conversion. And North Haven really jumping out to a nice quick start lead and a confidence builder for this offense and this team overall after last week's performance.
14-0. You're watching Friday Night Football on NHTV.
Arnold's Jewelers, the North Haven Diamond Center, 117 Washington Avenue in North Haven. Decades of experience and a deep commitment to the North Haven community. Visit us today at thearnoldsjewelers.net.
North Haven Funeral Home, 36 Washington Avenue, North Haven. Since 1953, the one source families rely on for caring, compassionate service. North Haven Funeral Home.
Brandon Stevens returns an interception for the touchdown, giving North Haven a 14-0 lead after the two-point conversion from Joey Mastriani to Anthony Perillo. First time we've called the name Anthony Perillo this season on NHTV. And after the kick was made, a whistle's blown, so this one's going to come back.
Could be an illegal procedure against North Haven.
Looked like someone might have jumped the gun there, and they'll have to re-kick, a penalty on North Haven. So, got to say here, the kicker for North Haven, Eli Reynolds, a freshman, got himself a little leg there.
Hey, it's crazy to just know that you're seeing more and more teams adding these freshman kids. But hey, if you can play the game of football, it don't matter what level you're at. If you can play the game of football and you can impact and contribute to the team, anybody will have you on the team. And in a situation like this, you see North Haven with McCormick, and now you see the kicker as a freshman. That's a heck of a job.
This one will be returned. Broke a tackle. Stiff arms another, and he's going to break free to the 40. He only got one man to beat. He will break it in. Touchdown, Xavier. They answer right back with a kickoff return for the touchdown by William Reber, 80 yards to the house.
And just like North Haven needed a much-needed play on their defense, Xavier comes back and says, hey, we're not out of this game. What a huge momentum swing now. Special teams, I think that's the first special teams touchdown we've seen this season now, too. So we got a pick six. There's a lot of things that's been happening this year since we came back together. And now you see a huge play by Xavier. And hey, ladies and gentlemen, the Falcons are saying, we're not out of it yet.
A team that started winless in the first few weeks of the season and on a winning streak right now. Obviously, you can't count them out, even though they were down two scores. And bing, bang, boom, we got ourselves a one-score game again. Xavier will kick the extra point here. It'll be the left-footed Clark Beattie for the extra point. And a timeout call by North Haven with 7:39 to go. We'll take a quick timeout here. You're watching Friday Night Football on NHTV.
The Rotary Club of North Haven, where the business community comes together. For personal growth and leadership development, Rotary makes one a better community citizen. For more information, please visit nhrotary.org today. Arnold's Jewelers, the North Haven Diamond Center, 117 Washington Avenue in North Haven. Decades of experience and a deep commitment to the North Haven community. Visit us today at thearnoldsjewelers.net.
So we await the extra point here after the timeout by North Haven.
That leaves North Haven one timeout, Michael. One timeout left with 8 minutes left.
Clark Beattie will kick the extra point. Snap is good. Kick is up. And it is good. So after North Haven returns an interception for a touchdown, Xavier comes right back and returns an 80-yard kickoff for the touchdown. And with 7:39, we have a one-score game, a very tight matchup here, just like last week where the first half was a very well-contested game. Yep. So how can North Haven carry this over into the second half? They struggled last week.
Yeah.
Can they bring it into this week and make those adjustments and come through with a victory here?
Well, you're already seeing them get after the quarterback, after Andrea. You're seeing them run the ball effectively. You're seeing them throw the ball effectively. And then you're seeing the defense making huge play with the pick six. So they're doing a lot of things right. It's a quick little hiccup that just you saw Xavier take advantage of the green, a lot of green in front of him, and a heck of a play, a much-needed play. Like I said, much-needed play for both of these units, the special teams of the Falcons, and then the Nighthawks defense, the secondary specifically, just a huge confidence builder for them moving forward. So how does North Haven respond where there's been a lot of action the last two plays, Michael?
High end over end kick off the chest of Brandon Stevens. He's going to have to return this one. Has room, and he's going to make something out of nothing. Are you kidding me? Could he run this one back to the 30 and been tackled behind just shy of the 35-yard line. So Brandon Stevens, who had that pick six for the touchdown, almost caused a huge blunder there, mishandling the kickoff inside the five. Jukes a couple tackles out of the way, finds some open field, and gets it to the 35-yard line. That's a pretty impressive return by Stevens.
That's a lot of running right there. I mean, think about the last four plays we've seen in this game. Pick six, a throwback pass, two-point conversion, a big touchdown from the Falcons, and then it looked like Reggie Bush back in the day at USC trying to, try to make some plays. And Stevens has had a nice little impact on this Nighthawks team tonight.
First and 10 from the 35. Mastriani goes between the tackles, lowers a shoulder, and he gets about 7 yards on that first down carry.
And he's just feeding off of what he did last week, where he's just lowering his shoulder and getting those 6 to 7 yards. And that's a huge deal for Coach Sagnella. If he can continue to run like this, it's going to be a long night for this Falcons defense.
Second down and short for North Haven, just under 7 minutes to go in the second quarter. McCormick hands it off, gets the first down. That's Chris Cretella, just shy of the 50-yard line. So North Haven gets the first down.
Misdirection. It's one of North Haven's most successful plays to me, because I used to run this play back in the heyday. This used to be my play, and it always had some sort of success. Wonder, maybe just because people can't get used to the misdirection. Sometimes these teams, they know what's coming, and they still can't have an answer. It is a fascinating thing to watch this North Haven offense when they are gelling.
DeMauro takes the snap, fakes the handoff, crosses midfield, and tackled at the 48-yard line. So a four-yard carry for DeMauro gives them a second and six. So we're seeing a lot of people touching this football, too. You have, obviously, Mastriani McCormick, who usually lead the rushing team, but we're hearing DeMauro getting a couple carries tonight. Cretella, obviously, is usually the third man that gets the ball, but, you know, even a guy like Anthony Perillo touching the football tonight that we usually don't call his name.
Yeah.
So a lot of involvement tonight for North Haven.
The more the merrier.
Carry to the near side, around the edge to the sidelines, and that's going to be a first down for the freshman, Artie McCormick.
And it's good to see him at 100%, because if we do remember from last week, he did have a little injury, hobbled it with the ankle, but he is back. He looks like Artie McCormick, what he's been doing all year, that burst outside, getting the first down for North Haven, and that's a positive sign for this North Haven Nighthawk offense.
So North Haven at the 36-yard line for first and 10. Mastriani behind center here with DeMauro. DeMauro takes the snap, goes wide open there through the tackles, and close to the first down marker, carry of 8 yards for DeMauro, and he's getting a lot more involved in the running game tonight.
Yeah, last week was Joey Mastriani. They used McCormick as like a decoy. Now it seems like they're using Mastriani. They're still using Mastriani heavily in this offense, in the game plan, but they're also using him as a decoy too. And now you're just, like I said, DeMauro's getting involved. We're seeing a lot more names tonight being called by the great Michael Valenti.
McCormick gets the snap, goes between the tackles again, trying to zigzag his way through, and pinballs his way to the 15-yard line. So that's going to be another North Haven first down, and they're in the red zone yet again.
And they're really just slowing this, milking this clock. It just seems like we already have 5 minutes left in the first half, and North Haven has, what is this, 3 or 4 possessions in the game. Great job. Job well done for North Haven. If they can continue to move the ball like this, where they want to play at their own pace, it's going to be, like I said, a long night for this defense.
Mastriani hands it off to Cretella. No, he doesn't. That was a fake out there. The cameraman fooled me.
Got to play flag, too. Looks like it's going to be on the Xavier. Definitely looks like Xavier.
Yeah, I think it was some contact out of bounds there as Mastriani left the in play. So this one's going to be on Xavier, personal foul. Their second personal foul of the night, if it is, in fact, their personal foul.
It'll be a personal
yes,
foul
it is. So that's going to put North Haven in a first and goal situation. And this is a big one. 4:37 to go here in the second quarter. Xavier has all three of their timeouts.
Yep.
North Haven only has one, but North Haven gets the ball back to start the second half. So one of those situations where, you know, you have people that question, why are coaches deferring on the coin toss?
Opening. But I love it. It's
but this, but this is where, this is where it comes to their advantage, because they have the lead. They look like they could add on to it. Late in the second quarter, they get the ball back, and they can even add more before they even get a chance to touch the football. McCormick trying to get around to the edge. Sneaks through.
Breaking tackles.
Breaking some tackles, and he is...
Another flag.
Some flags that are away from the camera.
This is getting it's a very chippy game right now. Xavier North Haven going at it. Another flag. I don't know who's going to be on this time, Michael, but you're seeing back-to-back plays very chippy on that sidelines.
It was away from where the play was, so I didn't exactly see what was happening, but this is a North Haven penalty and Xavier, so this will offset.
So it looks like the refs are going to have their hands full tonight, because we're only early on in the first half, and we got some chippiness going on in that sidelines. This is where both Coach Sagnella and Xavier's coaching staff has to get these guys composed. You don't want to lose anybody to injury or to getting ejected from a game or personally hurting your team in a situation down and distance-wise.
Mastriani trying to punch it in, but... won't make it. So it'll be third down and goal with just at the 4 minute mark here in the second quarter. Be sure to stay with us here at halftime. We have the North Haven High School band performing. We'll have highlights from the first half and keys to the second half here on NHTV. Third and goal from the 1 yard line. North Haven trying to punch it in and extend their 14-7 lead. It'll be McCormick with DeMora. The shift to the right side. Direct snap goes to McCormick, trying to sneak through the guard in center, and he will be in the end zone for the touchdown. So Artie McCormick gets back into the pay dirt. He didn't score last week, but he's back in there this week.
Okay, right at the 1 yard line. You knew North Haven was going to 22. The whole state of Connecticut knew North Haven was going to give the ball to Artie McCormick, and they had no answer right there. So North Haven, once again, in the red zone. Nice drives. I mean, you really think about these drives from North Haven. Slow, methodical, but they're playing at their pace and playing where they want to do and where they want to be right now. And that's why they're up 20-7, pending the extra point.
Eli Reynolds. Kick is up and true. So North Haven with 3:25 to go here in the second quarter has the lead. You're watching Friday Night Football on NHTV.
North Haven Funeral Home, 36 Washington Avenue, North Haven. Since 1953, the one source families rely on for caring, compassionate service. North Haven Funeral Home.
The Rotary Club of North Haven, where the business community comes together. For personal growth and leadership development, Rotary makes one a better community citizen. For more information, please visit nhrotary.org today.
So, Artie McCormick punches it in from a yard out to give North Haven the 21-7 lead with just under 3.5 to go here in the second quarter. Michael Valenti alongside Trevor Keys for a... It got a little chippy there, a little physical, and we'll see how that carries on into the second half of this game.
That's part of football. It's an emotional game, but can they stay composed is where you don't want to go crazy. Don't lose total control, because you might lose one of your key players. You're hurting the team in that sense, too. So hopefully it was just a quick little situation.
Reynolds will kick this one short, and it goes off the shins of Weber and will be returned by number 6, Dylan Gassner, breaks one tackle, Stiff arms off another tackle, stays on the ground, and eventually brought down at the 28-yard line. So Gassner doing a little pinball action there and gives... Oh, and he comes up limping on the return.
We'll definitely have to monitor that. He's one of their go-to guys offensively. So we'll definitely have to monitor that, Michael. But, special teams-wise for Xavier, they're breaking, avoiding a lot of tackles right now. North Haven, definitely my big thing that I've seen in the first half, because defensively they're playing great. Offensively they're playing great. Special teams, they have to be better at staying at home, making tackles, where you're seeing a lot of broken tackles. And like I also saw early on in this game, you saw a big touchdown from this special teams of the Falcons.
First and 10 from the 24-yard line, shotgun formation. Xavier has all three of their timeouts here with 3:15 to go in the second. Andrea looks to throw. He's going to throw this one deep to the far side. Has a man open, but overthrows him. Intended for Michael Waters.
Oh, he had him. If he throws him in stride, if he gets him perfectly, that's a touchdown right there. Looks like he was going deep. First throw we've seen deep from Andrea tonight. A lot of the short passes we've seen early on, but he's taking a chance, taking a shot, especially knowing that Xavier's down two scores right now with 3 minutes left. A huge, huge drive for this Falcons offense, knowing, like Michael said, North Haven's getting the ball in the second half.
Second and 10 after the incomplete pass to Waters. Pringle will get the carry. Helmet flies off. And I think North Haven might have recovered a fumble. Yes, they did.
Wow. What is going on? Look at this. We got helmets all over the place. We got the football. I did not see. That's Pringle's second fumble. I did not see a fumble.
Yeah, it was there. It was there.
Was it late? It came out late?
It came out late, yeah.
Okay. Well, that's two fumbles by Pringle.
I didn't see who got the recovery, but North Haven definitely got that one. That rolled off. Pringle was the man that carried that ball into the ground. So North Haven, with their third turnover of this game, two forced fumbles on Pringle tonight, and the pick six.
And Coach Velarde must be loving it on the sidelines.
So first and 10 from the 27-yard line. DeMauro hands this one off to Cretella. Stiff arms, one guy. And carried into the 17-yard line. So close to the first down mark. I think that one's going to move over. So another North Haven first down.
And North Haven continues every play. And when they continuously have these 7, 8, even first down, it just continues to build the confidence in this offense. Because like I said, yes, we're going into week 7. Got a couple weeks left. North Haven is really trying to find that identity for the last month. And who's it going to be? Is it just going to continue to stick to this run game, which has always been working? And who are they going to use? Who do they want to get involved in this offense?
Timeout taken. With 2:36 to go, you're watching Friday Night Football on NHTV.
Arnold's Jewelers, the North Haven Diamond Center, 117 Washington Avenue in North Haven. Decades of experience and a deep commitment to the North Haven community. Visit us today at thearnoldsjewelers.net.
North Haven Funeral Home, 36 Washington Avenue, North Haven. Since 1953, the one source families rely on for caring, compassionate service. North Haven Funeral Home.
.236 to go, coming off the timeout here. North Haven leading 21-7, trying to add even more to that lead after recovering a fumble, the second one of the night, from Ian Pringle. And North Haven with McCormick and DeMauro behind center here on the near side.
15-yard line.
From the 15. Ball goes on the ground. McCormick able to pick it up and recover. But he's going to lose yardage on that play. So McCormick, the second time tonight, mishandling a snap.
Yeah, right into his hands. Another bobble snap. Thankfully, he picked it up just like the first time. And a great job by Xavier's front. The Xavier's bringing all the big boys in for this because they know this could be, I know that we're talking first half, but it almost feels like it could be a do-or-die situation for this defense, knowing that North Haven's going to get the ball starting in the second half. So how does Xavier find a way to get off the field and get back on the offense and try to cut into this lead?
Tomorrow lowers the shoulder there.
Ty DeMauro on the carry. Gets back to the original line.
He gets to the original line of scrimmage, so it'll be third and 10 from the 20-yard line.
Is he the leading ball carrier tonight?
I'd have to look at the stat sheet.
It feels like he's been getting called the ball a lot tonight, which is surprising because usually it's been a two-man show with McCormick and Mastriani, but now we're seeing DeMauro getting heavily involved in the rushing attack.
And Chris Cartella has a few carries as well. This time it is McCormick gets to the 10-yard line. So it'll be fourth and five from the 10-yard line. So we'll see if Coach Sachs goes for it on fourth down or does he bring in Eli Reynolds. But he'll call a timeout here with a minute 49 to go in the second quarter. You're watching Friday Night Football on NHTV.
The Rotary Club of North Haven, where the business community comes together. For personal growth and leadership development, Rotary makes one a better community citizen. For more information, please visit nhrotary.org today. Arnold's Jewelers, the North Haven Diamond Center, 117 Washington Avenue in North Haven. Decades of experience and a deep commitment to the North Haven community. Visit us today at thearnoldsjewelers.net.
Coming off the timeout here, a minute 49 to go in the second quarter. North Haven with a 21-7 lead, a fourth and three from the 9-yard line. Eli Reynolds was warming up for the field goal, but it looks like North Haven will keep the offense on and go for it.
Coach Sachs may be trying to put the nail in the coffin early on in this game. You go up three scores heading into half with the way your defense has been playing in this first half as well. It's going to be tough sledding for this Falcons team overall.
Fourth and three from the 9. Mastriani rolls out, looks to throw, has a man open in the corner, and it is! Did he get both feet in? Yes, he did! Brandon Stevens with his second touchdown of the night!
And look at that, you see him, and the second, the corner, number 17, knew what was coming, it looked like they were going to run with Mastriani, he came too far up the field, and you saw the blown coverage right there, as Stevens again, with another touchdown, and a heck of a day for the offense, for the number 2. Stevens is having a heck of a day. And I think it's only 1 foot in high school.
Well, either way, it was in. He got both feet in.
Did he?
He did get both feet in, it looked like.
He would have been in the NFL. He would have made it in college, and he would have made it in high school.
Reynolds with the line drive through the uprights and good. So North Haven adds on with Brandon Stevens' second touchdown of the game. 28-7, 1:44 to go. You're watching Friday Night Football on NHTV.
North Haven Funeral Home, 36 Washington Avenue, North Haven. Since 1953, the one source families rely on for caring, compassionate service. North Haven Funeral Home.
The Rotary Club of North Haven, where the business community comes together. For personal growth and leadership development, Rotary makes one a better community citizen. For more information, please visit nhrotary.org today.
So Brandon Stevens gets a touchdown from the defensive side of the ball and the offensive side of the ball. And we're going to have to check the record books on this one. The last time we had a offensive and defensive touchdown from one player from North Haven in the same game, I definitely know Mike Montano did it, as there's a squib kick here, and this one almost recovered. Actually,
still on the ground.
That ball was still on the ground. Did North Haven catch that?
Catch him off guard. Wow. I like it.
No signal yet.
It looks like, it's Xavier.
It will go to Xavier.
But I like the thinking. I really do. Catch him off guard with a squib kick. Because I understand probably why they did this too. Because of the success that Xavier has had early on in this game, special teams-wise, scoring the touchdown and being able to make plays, they want to keep the ball away from the returner. So I like the thinking by Coach Sags and the coaching staff.
So North Haven with the lead, 28-7. Xavier with a minute 44 and two timeouts here to try to keep this a two-score game heading into the half. North Haven gets the ball back to start the second half. Pringle will take the carry, finds an open field and breaks through. McCormick's the only one left that Pringle could beat, and he gets him. The freshman takes down the senior. What a play by Artie McCormick.
A heck of a play, and Pringle's had a tough night so far, but that will get the coaching staff of Xavier excited to see their big fella running like that. Look at the hole just open up, and it was almost Painter, but Artie McCormick, he's just a heck of a player, offensively, defensively. He really does it all for North Haven. So we'll see what Xavier does now. It's been a long time since we've seen Xavier in the red zone. No, this is the first time in the red zone. They really haven't had a lot of success offensively against this defensive front of North Haven. So we'll see how they handle going in, possibly with a minute left, and try to cut down and make it a two-touchdown game, Michael.
So Pringle gets the carry again, gets 4 yards on the carry, 1 minute to go, and Xavier is not really...
They're not huddling and rushing. But they still got the two timeouts too, which if we'll see what they do after this play. It is second down. Maybe they call a timeout after this play.
Andrea takes it himself, breaks a couple tackles, still on his feet, and he's going to be just shy of the goal line. So first and goal, and they take a timeout here with 33 seconds to go. So, you know, going back a couple plays with McCormick and Pringle. Pringle, you know, he's no small dude there. He's a big dude. And you got Artie McCormick, who's coming into this game a freshman. 5'6", 5'7"
Yeah.
Maybe 150 pounds at
most.
But
that's what you got to do with a big back, Michael. You got to go for the legs. You got to take him out. Because if you're going head-on with him, it might have been a different result for Xavier and North Haven. But what can I say else about Artie McCormick? I've been just so impressed with watching him every home game that I've seen. And also on the road this year, going to East Harvard, having a 300-yard performance, 6-touchdown game. That's a special talent for a kid that, yeah, we keep saying it. I don't think we're going to keep saying the freshman anymore because he's established himself as a true ball player for this offense, moving not just this season, but for the next 3 years as well.
So first and goal, Falcons from the 1 yard line.
The Falcons have first and goal from the one, trying to make it a two score game. Shotgun formation, man in motion. And it's a direct snap to Justin Pringle, and he will get into the end zone for the touchdown.
Yeah, like what they did. They bring the motion, get him under center quick. Oh, catch him off guard. I'll take that for you right there. And Xavier cuts into the lead. A huge, much-needed drive from this Xavier offense right there. And Pringle, who has struggled holding onto the ball, really set them up for a perfect situation. And they really took advantage of the short field. So now North Haven, with 30 seconds left, most likely will go into the half up 2 touchdowns, knowing they're going to get the ball back. How do they make the adjustments defensively and special teams-wise?
Clark Beattie will kick the extra point here for Xavier. Snap is good. Hold is good. Kick is up and through the uprights. So we have a 14-point game heading into the half. 29 seconds left in this half. So North Haven could run it back. We don't know.
Well, we've seen Stevens last return, made a play out there. So we'll see what he does right here. The special teams, both teams' special teams have been performing well tonight.
Yeah, I mean, field position has not been a question for either team.
No.
And when they've had good field position, they've taken advantage of it for the most part. And
I
mean,
they're really scoring game.
It is a pretty high scoring.
42 points in the first half.
Yeah, and really the difference here is the turnovers. You have Ian Pringle with two fumbles.
Yep.
And you also have Sam Andrea with an interception tonight that unfortunately went for a pick six in for North Haven.
And those three turnovers accumulated to 14 points where North Haven is up right now 14 points. So this is a different ball game. If Pringle doesn't have the two fumbles and the pick six by Stevens, could be a whole different ball game. But that's a job well done to the defense of North Haven.
So this one will be kicked and looks like will be returned. He's got open field. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? To the 40, to the 30, and he's tackled at the 25-yard line. What a return by by Chris Cottage.
This is a specialty. He saw, look at that. Saw their all hole up and up, and he was off almost a painter, but a heck of an effort by the big fella of Xavier. Now this changes everything for North Haven. Yeah, they got no timeouts, but they were probably thinking, all right, we're just going to get the ball. We'll kneel. We'll go down back into halftime up two scores. But this changes everything for now for North Haven. What do they do with 19 seconds left? A big play, big pass play, maybe misdirection, reverse. North Haven has an opportunity to really extend this lead. And boy, that would be such a big momentum swing. Xavier thinking they're going to be down only two touchdowns, but North Haven opportunity is at an all-time high right here.
Mastriani evades the sack, evades a second sack, still on his feet, and he gets to a one-yard carry. That could have been an eight-yard loss. They have 8 seconds left and no timeout, so that's going to be the end of the half.
And
North Haven will go into the half with a two-touchdown lead. And it was an exciting end to this half, just like last week we had an exciting end to the first half.
Very exciting.
But the difference is North Haven with the lead, as opposed to last week where they were trailing.
42 points in the first half. We've had a pick six. We've had almost two return touchdowns. North Haven's running the ball effectively. They're getting after the quarterback. And we got fireworks. We got a heck of a first half right here. How does North Haven make the adjustments going into the second half? They feel like they're confident enough offensively. Defensively, do they continue to play the way they've been playing? Getting after Andrea and being aggressive, trying to go for that ball. You've seen Pringle drop it twice. Can they go after it again?
All right, at the half, North Haven 28, Xavier 14. And now a performance by the North Haven High School Band here at the half. And just a reminder, our snack check.
Arnold's Jewelers, the North Haven Diamond Center, 117 Washington Avenue in North Haven. Decades of experience and a deep commitment to the North Haven community. Visit us today at thearnoldsjewelers.net.
North Haven Funeral Home, 36 Washington Avenue, North Haven. Since 1953, the one source families rely on for caring, compassionate service. North Haven Funeral Home.
Club of North Haven, where the business community comes together for personal growth and leadership development. Rotary makes one a better community citizen. For more information, please visit nhrotary.org today. Arnold's Jewelers, the North Haven Diamond Center, 117 Washington Avenue in North Haven. Decades of experience and a deep commitment to the North Haven community. Visit us today at thearnoldsjewelers.net.
A pick six by North Haven. You had a kickoff return right off of that. Return for a touchdown by Xavier. Making a close one. Here are the highlights here. Starting it off, Tyler DeMoral, a guy that we haven't really heard from all season long. He's been getting a lot of carries tonight. And then big run there to set this one up from Joe Mastriani. Touchdown, giving North Haven the 6-0 lead. But immediately following that, North Haven goes for the extra point, and it's blocked. That was pretty much it for the first quarter. Everything really happened in the second quarter. Joe Mastriani on fourth down gets the conversion to Brian Moran, but they score, or they don't. They fail to score, and leads to this. Sam Andrea, interception to Brandon Stevens. Gets into the end zone for the touchdown. His first of two touchdowns in the first half. Joey Mastriani for the two-point conversion. Looks right, fakes to the left, and a two-point conversion to Anthony Perillo. Immediately following that, it is William Weber from 80 yards out. Breaks a couple tackles and gets to the end zone for a touchdown and making this game interesting. You thought North Haven was going to break free, but no, they don't. Ensuing kickoff off the chest of Brandon Stevens, and he's going to return this one. Basically making a whole heck of a lot of nothing there. Returns this one all the way to the 35-yard line, moving it all the way to a first and goal situation. Artie McCormick back into the end zone for a touchdown. He was silenced last week after a 6-touchdown performance. And then another touchdown here. Brandon Stevens, his second one. Both feet get in. Only needs one in high school, but both feet get in. So then, handoff to Ian Pringle. Big run here. Looks like he's going to make it to the end zone. But look at the freshman, Artie McCormick, saving the day. But still, eventually, Xavier gets into the end zone. It's Justin Pringle that gets it into the end zone. Ensuing kickoff return, Chris Cottage breaking free, crossing midfield to the 40, 35, 30, and just tackled there before the end of the half. And North Haven just finding ways to move that football, getting good field position, and getting it into the end zone. Something we didn't really see in the first half. We're going to take a quick break here, and we come back. Trevor Keys and I will have the second half keys. You're watching Friday Night Football on NHTV.
North Haven Funeral Home, 36 Washington Avenue, North Haven. Since 1953, the one source families rely on for caring, compassionate service. North Haven Funeral Home.
The Rotary Club of North Haven, where the business community comes together. For personal growth and leadership development, Rotary makes one a better community citizen. For more information, please visit nhrotary.org today.
At the half, North Haven leads this one 28-14. Michael Valenti alongside Trevor Keys. A very impressive first half for North Haven there. And Xavier's not quitting just yet. They found their ways. They just put the ball on the ground a couple times, and an interception led to a touchdown. Yeah. And that's really the difference in this game, Trevor.
Yeah, but if you think about it, I mean, we're thinking it's going to be 28-7 going into half. North Haven's going to get the ball. Xavier comes right down the big, big run to kind of save maybe the game for them. And then they set themselves up for a nice, easy touchdown, and now we got a two-score game. So this is going to be the driving game for both of the teams. North Haven, can they continuously slow the game down like they've been doing and methodically running the football with, I mean, it's been everybody. It's not just the Mastriani and the McCormick game. It's everyone. You're seeing DeMoro getting involved. Stevens has had a heck of an impact tonight. Can they continue to just do what they've been doing? Run the football, control the line of scrimmage, control the tempo, and can Xavier find a way to make a stop? You saw them make a big stop early on in the game, big sack that avoided North Haven some more points. Can Xavier try to get off the field? A huge, huge drive. The defense for Xavier and offensively for North Haven can continue to be doing what they feed off in the first half.
Now, North Haven's going to get the ball to start this second half. Yeah. What do they have to do to add on to this lead? Do they do some misdirection? Do we see passing?
No.
It seems like the passing game has been working.
Yeah.
But running the football is something they've always done. As we're actually seeing a little bit of wind blowing here.
The wind has been kind of, it's been playing a game with us tonight. The wind is there, here, but right now we're looking at the wind. It is still windy. Honestly, Michael, yeah, they have the passing touchdowns to Stevens. Just keep running the ball. I mean, you're up. You're not trailing. You're in a situation where you want to be in. Run the football. Your confidence is there. You're having confidence with your running backs, your players all around, even defensively. Just continue to do what you're doing, because Xavier realistically doesn't have an answer so far for this offense.
No, they really don't. But the adjustments could be made, and this is a team that seems very resilient.
Yeah.
They started the season winless.
Yeah.
They've been on a winning streak.
Yeah.
So this game is far from over. The fact that it's a two-touchdown game doesn't really mean much. You know, the kickoffs have been
it's crazy. It's been kickoffs. Look how heavily involved they've been. We've almost had two return touchdowns. It's been a fun game. We were talking at the end of the first half. 42 points in the first half. If it's anything like it's going to be in the second half. We're in for a show tonight, Michael.
Yes, we are. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, the second half, North Haven starts with the ball. You're watching Friday Night Football on NHTV.
Arnold's Jewelers, the North Haven Diamond Center, 117 Washington Avenue in North Haven. Decades of experience and a deep commitment to the North Haven community. Visit us today at thearnoldsjewelers.net.
North Haven Funeral Home, 36 Washington Avenue, North Haven. Since 1953, the One Source families rely on for caring, compassionate service. North Haven Funeral Home.
We're just about ready here for the start of the second half. Michael Valenti alongside Trevor Keys. 28-14, North Haven leads. They will start with the ball in the second half. I mean, we assume they're going to start with the ball in the second half, but perhaps Xavier tries something
or
tries something and goes with the onside kick.
Or maybe North Haven just joins the return party and scores one themselves, because we almost saw one at the end where North Haven, we thought, oh, 19 seconds left, they're going to be able to maybe extend this lead. Luckily for Xavier, they didn't, but we've seen a lot of action on this special team, so I'm very curious to see. You already saw also North Haven kind of squib kick it last time, because maybe they don't have full trust in their special teams unit right now because of the way that Xavier's greatest success tonight has been through the special teams.
Yeah, one thing that I've noticed is a lot of missed tackles. They've gotten to the returners in pretty deep territory, but they've broken one, two, three tackles. They get to the second level, and there's open space for those big returns.
And that's been like it seems like to me, from what we've seen for these games, these four home games this year, one of the big glaring weaknesses that I've seen is the tackling. North Haven has had struggles with tackling the ball carrier, whether it's through special teams or defensively, offensively. They've had a hard time tackling ball carriers, and that's one thing that they're going to have to do better in the second half, because if not, you could see another return touchdown, or you could see another big run from Xavier like it did at the end of the first half.
So North Haven will start with the ball after deferring the coin toss. And this one, could we say this game comes down to this drive? Is it too early to say that?
No, because of the way that North Haven's been able to move the ball, but also with the way they've been able to chew the clock down. And Xavier wants to be throwing the ball. They want to be in their type of tempo of offense, where North Haven's just going to chew that clock, and that's their best friend. And if they continue to chew the clock, Xavier's never going to get an opportunity to get back in this game. So, yes, to say the least, I know it's going into the second quarter or third quarter right now, but yes, this could be the drive of the game. It could be too early to tell, but with the way both units have been playing in the first half, this could be a make or break for both teams.
So they add an extra 2 minutes to the end of this halftime as we get set for the start of the second half, as Xavier kind of got a little late to the field coming out of the locker room at halftime. But the special teams is ready for North Haven. They're ready to return this one.
I'm excited to watch special teams tonight.
Yeah.
Usually it's not as entertaining, but with the way this game has gone, where you've seen multiple opportunities of big plays from both units, that, hey, maybe we do see a return from North Haven right here.
Yeah, we'll take a quick break. When we come back, the start of the second half, you're watching Friday Night Football on NHTV.
Rotary Club of North Haven, where the business community comes together. For personal growth and leadership development, Rotary makes one a better community citizen. For more information, please visit nhrotary.org today. Arnold's Jewelers, the North Haven Diamond Center, 117 Washington Avenue in North Haven. Decades of experience and a deep commitment to the North Haven community. Visit us today at thearnoldsjewelers.net.
North Haven will start with the ball here to start the second half with the lead, 28-14. Michael Valenti alongside Trevor Keys, and a lot of people, a lot of different Nighthawks are touching the ball, getting involved in this game. We've seen Artie McCormick get into the end zone tonight. Mm-hmm. Joe Mastriani throwing to Anthony Perillo for a two-point conversion. Brandon Stevens has two touchdowns, one on the defensive side of the ball, one on the offensive side of the ball.
Mm-hmm. And that's the great thing about the offense. If you could just continuously add these playmakers to this game plan and get them involved, which they are right now tonight, you're seeing what this offense can do.
So we're just awaiting Xavier to get onto the field to start the second half and kick this one off. Even Joe Mastriani, he scored the first touchdown of the night, and he has a passing touchdown tonight. So,
yeah.
And I believe he was one of the two fumble recoveries tonight.
From
Ian Pringle, okay. Yes. And we also had Tyler DeMoro's having himself a good game. He's getting heavily involved in the running game. Also had a sack in the first half.
A couple sacks you've seen in the game, a pick six. So they're doing what they want to do defensively. It's just a couple little things, little breakdowns of just being able to tackle. That's the biggest thing is, can they be able to get these guys one-on-one tackles? You saw McCormick, a huge tackle, saving from the big play. Eventually, they did score, but the one-on-one tackle against Pringle late in that first half, can North Haven get better at tackling in the second half?
This is short and will be returned by Brandon Stevens, and he pitches it back to open field to the 30, to the 35. Curtella still on his feet and tiptoes out of bounds.
What did I say? I said, I'm looking forward to special teams, and now we get a reverse. Look, I saw it once. He was like, yep, reverse. Great job right there, seeing over-pursuing on the Falcons' special teams unit, and then a heck of a play. What a great play call right there. And, hey, North Haven's in great field position, so I'm looking forward to special teams. Specifically, the kick return game right now, because it's been very, very entertaining, to say the least.
On both sides, not just North Haven, yes. But Xavier obviously returned one for a touchdown earlier in the game. North Haven starts with one from the 43-yard line after the return from Curtella, and DeMoro finds open field, sneaks through the end zone, 35, 20, 15, 10, 5, Tyler DeMoro's in for a touchdown.
Wow, I mean, you can't have asked for a better start, Michael. Look at that, Tyler DeMoro, have yourself a night, my man. Look at, follows his block, and the rest is it's on him. They had defenders, he goes right by them. He doesn't have the greatest speed in the world, but he blew past all the defenders, and wow, we are 19 seconds into the second half, and North Haven is already on the board, so a very, very good sign for this North Haven Nighthawk team.
And Tyler DeMoro is a guy game that we never really called in the first three games of the season,
yeah,
here at Mike Vanacore Field, and he's got himself a big 57-yard touchdown run here to start the second half. The extra point from Reynolds is good. So 19 seconds into this second half, North Haven extends their lead. You're watching Friday Night Football on NHTV.
North Haven Funeral Home, 36 Washington Avenue, North Haven. Since 1953, the one source families rely on for caring, compassionate service. North Haven Funeral Home.
Rotary Club of North Haven, where the business community comes together. For personal growth and leadership development, Rotary makes one a better community citizen. For more information, please visit nhrotary.org today.
So a good kickoff return on the reverse from Brandon Stevens to Chris Curtella sets up a 57-yard touchdown run by Tyler DeMoro.
Now it's like, okay, Xavier, now I get to watch you on special team, the kick return, because they've had their own little magic over here with a big touchdown early on in the game, and they've been able to move the ball on special teams. So how do they answer back with the quick drive from North Haven, Michael?
Reynolds squibs this one, takes a couple bounces, and will be returned to the 20. Slips on his feet and slides just shy of the 25-yard line. So it looked like he could have had some open field there, but might have got too excited, fell on a banana peel, and slipped on his butt.
A banana. Well, we'll see what Xavier does coming back now offensively, knowing that they're down three touchdowns. I expect a lot of passes in the second half. Whereas North Haven, how do they go? Do they become conservative, play laid-back defense, or do they continue to be the aggressor and go after Andrea in this offense?
So Pringle will start with the ball. on Xavier's first possession here in the second half. It doesn't get much on that first carry.
And Pringle's been up and down this game. Had the two fumbles and then the massive big run to cut into the lead right going before going into the first half. And we got to see how they continue to incorporate him in this offense.
Second and nine from the 26-yard line. Shotgun formation for Xavier. Fakes the handoff. Andrea has time. Throws it up the middle. Complete. And nice tackle there by Joe Mastriani. No yards after the catch there by Justin Pringle.
Yeah, that's a great job. Another short throw. You've seen most of his throws tonight have been middle of the field, where I said in pregame, let's see how this linebacking crew watches the middle of the field. Do they stay in their zones? Do they let up? Do they give up on the soft coverages? And right there, Xavier trying to get something going just offensively. Knowing they're down three touchdowns, they really got to get going because this clock is running. And like I said, being down three touchdowns is not where the Xavier Falcons want to be.
And Pringle trying to get the first down, but he stopped shy of the first down marker.
It's going to be short of a first down.
So Xavier has a decision to make.
They got
to
go.
They got to go for it here.
This is four down territory. You're down three touchdowns. You have to.
This will give North Haven great field position if North Haven can make the stop here. Fourth and one from the 33, actually fourth and two from the 33-yard line.
I would expect a run to Pringle, but don't be surprised if Andrea keeps the ball right here and just to get the first down.
Pringle gets the first down and past the 35-yard line to the 37. So Xavier keeps the ball, but the clock continues to run.
Yeah, when you got the big back there, 1 yard. Feed them to them and give them the first down. See what they can do coming out of the third and short, or fourth and short, I should say.
Empty on the near side, three on the far side. Pringle goes far, tripped up as he tries to go around the edge there, but he'll pick up a couple nonetheless.
And it looks like Xavier's not abandoned the run game. Even though they're down three touchdowns, they are not abandoning this run game and not trying to be one-dimensional. But in a situation like this where you are running the ball, that chews away from the clock. And right now the clock is the worst enemy. So you want to see Xavier have a little more up-tempo and try to get on the board quickly and start throwing the ball. But right now they're not abandoning that run game.
Quick pass is complete behind the line of scrimmage and goes nowhere quickly as the pass was completed to number 41, Xavier Herrera Linares. And they get...
They lost
a yard on that one. So good job by the North Haven defense. Third and seven at the 41-yard line.
Outside of a few throws, a few plays, this North Haven defense really shut down this Xavier Falcons offense. And that's a job well done, especially coming off of last week where they had a struggle against West Haven, giving up almost 450 yards on the ground. But definitely a bounce back week for this defense.
The pass is, I think that bounced off the ground. Yes, it did. Incomplete. Intended for Michael Waters. So another fourth down situation here for Xavier, fourth and long. And they're going to bring out the punt team. Mastriani will be back deep for North Haven. And punting it for Xavier will be Clark Beattie. So North Haven doing a very good job on Xavier's first possession of the second half, preventing them from really going anywhere. They moved the chains a little bit, but that's about it. High snap. Beattie gets the punt off. It's a high punt. Mastriani will take it and hit immediately by Michael Waters on that play. And a flag comes in after that play. They didn't like something after that one.
Must have been some sort of taunting or something. But in that situation, what are you trying to do? You're on three touchdowns. What are you trying to taunt or celebrate or do anything? And trying to hurt your team in a situation where you come off and make a nice play, a tremendous play, and stopping a very good player in Joe Mastriani on the run. But then you go and shoot yourselves in the foot with that. That's just, that's not a bright spot right there. Not a great decision by Xavier right there. And now you give North Haven almost in Xavier territory with this penalty.
So the ball would have been at the 35-yard line. The 15-yard penalty brings them to midfield.
It should be right at midfield.
So North Haven only had one play on their first drive in the second half, and it was a 57-yard touchdown run by Tyler DeMauro.
Yeah. Now, I mean, right now, Xavier's just playing into North Haven's hand right now. This is what North Haven wants to do. 50-yard line, run the football. You're up three touchdowns. You're going to just – I do not expect – there's my bold prediction. Maybe you will see it. Don't know. I do not see another pass for the rest of the game from North Haven. Just because, well, you're up three touchdowns, run the football. They haven't had an answer for you. Might as well continue it.
First and 10 from midfield. And we – Mastriani, who is thrown down behind the line of scrimmage there. Tackle made by Lucas Harkins. And they lose about 3 yards on that play.
That was one of the few plays you've seen Xavier really get in the backfield, and North Haven really never was able to orchestrate anything right there. So a job well done.
Clock continues to run. Second down. Behind midfield now after the loss. McCormick gets the yardage back and then some. Round to the 47-yard line. So it'll be third and about 7 here for North Haven. As they will continue to run this clock out. Leading 35-14. And what is a must-win game here at Mike Vanacore Field. I mean, here on out, every game is a must-win.
Yeah.
With 3 games left in the regular season. Holding on to that 8th seed in the Class M standings. 3rd and 7. And Mastriani was going to go back to pass, but a flag is thrown on the snap.
I'm sorry to sound this, but thank you, because I made a bold prediction, and already they're going to go against me. So, but now it definitely looks like a situation where North Haven is going to have to pass the ball.
So it's a false start on North Haven. So it'll be 3rd and 12. We have seen Mastriani throw more than what we've seen other passing backs in previous years here. So Mastriani could definitely get the first down here in the air. He drops back, looks to throw, has a man, and overthrown, intended for Brian Moran, and North Haven will have to punt.
Yeah, that was just great coverage by Falcons. They really had it covered down. They looked like he was trying to go deep. Safety over the top, had help right there. Tries to go the underneath and just overthrows his receiver. So North Haven has to punt the ball, go back on defense. And given situations like this where you get a penalty, they got to put themselves in third and long, you kind of give, even though they're down 3 touchdowns, you give Xavier some sort of life knowing, hey, we get to go back on offense and try to cut into the lead.
Evan DeMauro will punt for North Haven. Dylan Gastner, who limped off the field earlier in this game, is back to receive this punt. High snap. Punt nearly blocked. Takes a bounce inside the 25 and rolls out inside the 15 or inside the 20 near the 15-yard line.
It looks like the 16, 17-yard line, Michael.
That's what it looks like for me here, too. 6:28 to go in the third quarter. North Haven leads 35-14. Michael Valenti alongside Trevor Keys. We appreciate you watching here on North Haven High School Football, Friday Night Football, whether you're watching on NHTV or on North Haven Television's YouTube channel. So Xavier looking to extend their winning streak. Have a tough hill to climb against this North Haven defense that pretty much have had all the answers tonight defensively, barring a couple of big big plays. 17-yard line. First and 10. They fake the handoff. Rolling out is Andrea, and he's going to be dropped at around the 21-yard line. So they got to gain about 4 there for the quarterback.
Andrea's trying to throw the ball, but it's just great coverage by North Haven where he has to decide to keep it. And it's a smart decision. You don't want to force anything, force a turnover, and give North Haven great field position again, where we've seen early on in the game with Pringle's fumble early in the game.
Second and 5 after the carry. Andrea looks to throw. Finds a man that is Pringle on the flat. 30, 35. And he's got the first down.
But he did fumble again. That was a heck of a hit right there. That's one-on-one. Pringle, who's a bigger back, looks like a big force of a back right there. And Stevens coming in and delivering the hit for a small guy. Stevens has had a heck of a game tonight. Pick six, receiving. Did he have the receiving touchdown?
Receiving touchdown.
So he's been all over the field for this Nighthawk team. And just another great play by him.
First and 10 from the 34. This time it's a handoff to number 29, Vincent Rivera. And there's a flag on the play around the line of scrimmage.
But there is a flag.
So let's see. This probably is going to be holding on Xavier. And the head coach is not liking that call.
Well, because Xavier gets the first down with Pringle, and they're moving the ball now. Now with a penalty like that, it's a setback. They want to be moving the ball as fast as they can, and instead, now you throw everything off with a little penalty, just like that. A little 5-yard penalty like that could throw everything out, could throw everything off, I should say, for a team.
So 5:38 to go in the third quarter. First and 20 now for Xavier after the holding penalty. Shotgun formation, two wide receivers on the near side, one on the far side. Andrea looks to throw. Takes it up, and he is hit and leveled there by number 30, Johnny Williston.
That's nice. That's a nice play. I like that. I like seeing stuff like that, Michael, right there. And look, that's another great job. Every time that Andrea's dropped back to pass, there's been nothing for him to throw. So that's a job well done, and credit to the secondary right now. The back end of the defense is doing a heck of a job. And Andrea, good job he lowered that shoulder, because who knows, could have been another fumble, but North Davis hitting tonight. They look fine. They're playing well defensively, and that is a huge, huge confidence builder moving forward for the rest of the year.
Andrea looks to throw. Throws this one deep. It is incomplete. Intended for Waters.
Michael Waters, intended receiver. The ball's overthrown. That's going to bring up third and long.
One of the first. I think that was the first pass that we've seen Andrea take a shot deep tonight, or two. I should say second time. And again, North Haven secondary is just doing a heck of a job of just staying at home, knowing their assignments, and not really doing anything differently. So it's working right now. And now Xavier's in a third and long. Do they pass it? Or do they, after this, do they go four down territory knowing that the clock is ticking?
Third and 15 from the 29. Andrea looks to throw. And he is hit as he throws. Joey Mastriani there to disrupt the play, and Xavier will punt on fourth down.
And they decided to bring a little pressure, and that's what happens. I say it to everybody, whether it's the NFL, college, if you bring pressure, it doesn't matter how good your quarterback is. If you bring pressure, the quarterback is not going to have enough time to process the decision, so go after him. You want to make him uncomfortable. You don't want to have a good quarterback sitting in the pocket and having all night. North Haven has done a tremendous job.
Oh, high snap, and Beattie's going to jump on it at the 3-yard line. So North Haven gets the ball first and goal from the 3-yard line.
So we've seen everything tonight. We've seen bad snaps from both teams, fumbles. We've seen pick sixes. We've seen returns. North Haven is going inside their own. I believe they're at the 1-yard line, it looks like right now. So North Haven, or five, I should say 4-yard line. North Haven looking like they're going to go up 4 scores right now. So we'll see. Last week, they had great opportunities to get in the end zone. Didn't capitalize, but tonight has been a different story, I should say.
And the crowd calling the NH chant. 4:40 to go here in the third. First and goal from the 4. DeMora up and in. His second touchdown of the night.
He's like, all right, I'm getting the ball. It's like, wow. He really, 2 touchdowns tonight. It just, easy. It's kind of been like that all night for North Haven running the football, where they've had nice chunk plays, 4, 5, 6, 7 yards, and then you had big plays with DeMar early on in the second half, big touchdown. So North Haven's really doing anything they want offensively, and even defensively, I'll say, Michael.
Now, if you had Tyler DeMorrow as a waiver wire pickup this week in your high school fantasy football league,
goodness.
You got yourself a lot of points tonight from him.
But there's a lot of people that are frustrated because they probably didn't pick him up. But who's having a, I mean, right now, Stevens is having a heck of a game, and now DeMorrow has two touchdowns. Both guys that we've called their names this year but haven't been involved like they have been tonight offensively, and that's a job well done and a credit to this coaching staff.
It absolutely is. 4:37 to go here in the third quarter. North Haven leads this one 42-14. And, I mean, really, it kind of feels like the opposite.
He doesn't even know what to say.
No. My point, exactly. I have a point here.
Okay.
Last week, you had North Haven losing to West Haven 32-7.
Yeah.
But the thing we brought up a lot was the score doesn't really show the full story.
Yeah.
Tonight, the score doesn't really show the whole story because while North Haven is leading this one 42-14, Xavier has really played them tight in this game. It's just the miscues have shot them in the foot over and over and over again.
Think about it. You had the two fumbles, Pringle early on in the game, that set them inside the 20. You just have that inside the 5. Then you have the Stevens pick 6. That's 21 points right there. So you're talking 21-14. You take those three plays away. But, hey, great job in North Haven of capitalizing on them.
Absolutely.
You have to. If you're given that, you got to capitalize, and North Haven has tonight.
And one thing that North Haven definitely is doing this week that they didn't do last week, they're converting in the red zone and getting those points on the board. Last week, they were 1-for-6. This week, I believe they are now 4-for-5 in the red zone tonight.
I bet they were doing a lot of red zone offense this past week with North Haven.
Ball will be picked up by Pringle.
Pringle will get the kickoff here and drop to the 36, maybe 37-yard line.
Looks like Xavier's going to have a first and 10 at about the 37-yard line.
So Xavier will get the ball at the 37-yard line. And what seems to be now getting to a point where every down is now going to be a passing down for Xavier.
But what we've seen is that they haven't abandoned fully that running game. So do they continue to stay with the running game? Or, like I just said, do they completely abandon and go pass from here on out? In a situation like this, down 4 scores, you would think they're going to start passing heavily right now.
Andrea back to pass.
The pass is complete to Waters.
It was incomplete.
Ruled incomplete.
Yeah, it looked like he had a catch. He had the out route. It looked like he was going right towards the out of bounds. Get it out of bounds. Short, second and short. But instead, he's looking, and he doesn't retrieve the ball in his hand. You got to hold on to that ball. Keep your eyes on the ball.
Second and 10. Andrea looks to throw again. Throws this one up the middle and intercepted again. This time it's Chris Cottage. And he slides out of bounds at the 47-yard line.
Wow.
Chris Cottage with his fourth interception of the year.
Cottage's fourth interception of the season.
And Andrea trying to go up the seam. Thought he had a guy, but just another great job of jumping the route. And another, like we just said, Stevens did that early on. Jumped the route, pick 6. Cottage jumps the route, and another pick for North Haven. And here we go again. North Haven sets themselves up in great field position. And Michael, you just said it not too long ago. I know it's 42-14, and who knows if they extend this lead, but this game, the score doesn't really show what's been going on in this game, actually, because of the way that Xavier's been shooting themselves in the foot throughout this game.
Romano gets the carry this time. Crosses the 45 and dropped at the 42.5-yard line.
Romano gets down to about the 42-yard line.
So we're going to start possibly seeing more reserves as we get closer to the fourth quarter here in North Haven with the 42-14 lead.
I don't think there's reserves. I just think that's what North Haven can do. When you have that many weapons offensively, you can just plug them in, let's go.
So it'll be second down and 4. Romano again goes to the outside. He's got the first down, and he's tackled just shy of the 30-yard line for a first down.
Well, DeMoro's at his game. McCormick has done it throughout this entire season. Mastriani's been doing it throughout the season. Now they added Nick Romano. It's just it is a nice thing to see when North Haven really is at a full steam ahead with this offense.
So Romano stays in with Joe Mastriani on this first and 10 from the 30-yard line. North Haven with the lead, 42-14. Whistle blown before the snap, and this one's coming back.
Legal procedure against North Haven.
That stops the clock, too, for momentarily. And the clock continues to run now. First and 15 from the 35-yard line. Romano and Mastriani in behind center. And it goes to Mastriani. And another whistle blown before the snap. And North Haven with another illegal procedure. So they lose 10 yards before a snap is even made here.
And it looked like Mastriani might have been gone if that play continues to unravel.
Mastriani getting the call from Coach Sags.
So it's going to be first and 20.
So now first and 20 after the two back-to-back illegal procedure penalties. Ball at the 40-yard line. Dropping back to throw is Mastriani. He's got a man deep and incomplete. Intended for Chris Cretella. Trying to get that first down conversion on first down and maybe catching Xavier off guard on that passing play there. .223 to go in this third quarter. North Haven, who came into this game as the eighth seed in the Class M standings, leading this one 42-14. Dropping back to throw again as Mastriani throws this one. And the pass is complete. Still on his feet is Brandon Stevens. Still trying to go. Shakes off another Falcon before... He actually was blown dead on forward progress, but might have broken out of that tackle, and that whistle might have been inadvertent.
Stevens has been, look at him, breaking tackles. He's done. That's two. No, he just, it's a man that just doesn't want to go down.
Injury timeout on the field.
So we have an injury timeout with 2 minutes to go in the third. You're watching Friday Night Football on NHTV.
Arnold's Jewelers, the North Haven Diamond Center, 117 Washington Avenue in North Haven. Decades of experience and a deep commitment to the North Haven community. Visit us today at thearnoldsjewelers.net.
North Haven Funeral Home, 36 Washington Avenue, North Haven. Since 1953, the one source families rely on for caring, compassionate service. North Haven Funeral Home.
Coming off the injury timeout, North Haven leading this one 42-14, and 2 minutes to go in the third. North Haven facing a third and 16. Mastriani fakes to the left, goes up the middle, gets a few yards, but well short of the first down marker. And North Haven will keep the offense on the field for this fourth and long situation.
Yeah, in a situation like this where you're up four scores, might as well keep the offense on, short field too. See what happens. I mean, hey, maybe misdirection. Maybe they run a little reverse. You saw a reverse on the return early on in the second, or to start the second half. So it may not be out of the question.
Fourth and 11. They need to get to the 20. Mastriani rolls left, looks to throw left. Pass is. Is he inbounds?
And pass is caught by Brandon Stevens, but unable to stay inbounds.
He cannot stay in bounds. So it's a turnover on downs. Brandon Stevens this time could not get his foot in. So Xavier gets the ball at the 31-yard line.
I like the play call. Great play call. Had him right there. Just missed him right there. But a great catch by Stevens. Just missed to keep the feet in bounds.
So Xavier has all three of their timeouts, 1:09 to go in this quarter, plus the entire fourth quarter to try to get back into this game, down 4 touchdowns. In a situation where pretty much it's here on out all passing.
Pretty much.
We've tried to see Sam Andrea try to throw deep.
No, well, I think they took Andrea out right
so,
now.
So after a couple of interceptions, we have a new quarterback. Clark Beatty is now in. And a whistle blown. And the flag is a legal procedure against Xavier.
I'd love to know if Andrea's hurt, or did they just say, let's take you out for the night and give the guy some reps? Very interesting knowing that it's still only in the third quarter. He's still got a whole nother quarter left, which maybe the coaching staff seen enough and they feel like Beatty gives him the best opportunity to get back into this game.
First and 15 after the penalty. Beatty drops back. Looks to throw. Throws a pass. It's complete to Waters. Waters is close to the first down marker. Gain of about 14 on that play. So we see Petey's first pass attempt, and it's a good one.
Yeah, it's got some zip on that ball right there. Saw a soft zone right there. Receiver right there. Delivered a great ball and a first down. So maybe they will run this offense with Petey moving forward for the rest of this game.
Xavier with a slow pace, no huddle. Beatty looks to throw again. Finds a man deep. It's Waters, and it's complete.
Pass is complete to Michael Waters.
And down at the 25-yard line. A beautiful pass there from Clark Beatty to Michael Waters. And Waters is not coming up after that play.
Might have lost. Yeah, I don't know what happened. A beautiful throw by Beatty. But if you look at the North Haven corner, he just stops. He kind of just stops as the ball's in midair. And don't know exactly what happened to the receiver right there.
Joe McDonough. And Waters is down, and we'll take a timeout here. 22 seconds left in the third. You're watching Friday Night Football on NHTV.
The Rotary Club of North Haven, where the business community comes together. For personal growth and leadership development, Rotary makes one a better community citizen. For more information, please visit nhrotary.org today. Arnold's Jewelers, the North Haven Diamond Center, 117 Washington Avenue in North Haven. Decades of experience and a deep commitment to the North Haven community. Visit us today at thearnoldsjewelers.net.
Coming off the injury timeout, Michael Waters, who caught a beautiful pass from Clark Beatty. And now Xavier's in striking distance to make this a 3-score game.
And Beatty's looked pretty good on his first two throws. One first throw, short intermediate throw, but it had some zip, and then a nice deep throw to his big receiver. And he saw man-to-man coverage, no safety help right there, and he delivers a great throw. So Xavier's in business right now, trying to go in.
Waters is off the field for this play. First and 10 for Xavier. Beatty drops back. Has time. Pushed out of the pocket now. Tries to throw it off his back foot and incomplete. Just got it out of the way there. Nearest receiver was Connor Gallarani.
Yeah, and that was the best decision from Beatty right there as he saw pressure coming from both sides of the ball. And he decides, got to throw the ball. Don't want to lose, especially knowing that they're down 4 scores. They're trying to cut into this lead. And if anything goes south, an interception or like this could likely mean that Xavier and this game could be wrapped up. But Xavier shows a little more life right there.
Second and 10. Beattie drops back. Looks to throw. And he was under pressure there. Incomplete. Applying the pressure was Brian Moran. And also Evan DeMore, I believe, was on that play.
I've been very impressed with this front of North Haven. They haven't really brought a lot of pressures, but when they do, they've gotten after the quarterback, whether it's Beattie or Andrea. But specifically, it seems like they've been running a three-down front, and the front, that front is getting the better of the Xavier experienced offensive line. That's one of the things they talked about this Xavier team, is that they had a returning entire offensive line from last year's team that made it to the playoffs. So it's a very big bright spot for North Haven.
Beattie takes it upon himself, and he's close to the first down marker. And that's going to be the end of the third quarter. We'll see where it's marked. It'll be fourth down when we come back from the break. You're watching Friday Night Football on NHTV.
North Haven Funeral Home, 36 Washington Avenue, North Haven. Since 1953, the one source families rely on for caring, compassionate service. North Haven Funeral Home.
The Rotary Club of North Haven, where the business community comes together. For personal growth and leadership development, Rotary makes one a better community citizen. For more information, please visit nhrotary.org today.
Fourth down and one. As we start the fourth quarter of this game, North Haven leading this one 42-14. Michael Valenti alongside Trevor Keys. Clark Beattie came in for Sam Andrea to start this drive for Xavier late in the third quarter. And he's had two big completions and made a run there for 9 yards on third down, giving them this fourth and short situation inside the 5 yard line.
Definitely has been a nice little bright spot for this. Definitely has been, like I was saying, definitely a nice bright spot for this Falcons offense to see Beattie come in, a couple of nice throws, and then a nice run right there to try to cut into this lead, and a huge fourth down for this Falcon team.
So Pringle takes a snap, trying to push through, and he's got the first down, close to the goal line.
Looks
and
like,
it will be a first and goal from the half-yard line. So Xavier converts on fourth down and keeps their hopes alive in this game as they start the fourth quarter in a first and goal situation.
Yeah, it looks like at first North Haven had him stop, but Pringle kept moving those feet. And he got the much-needed first down for Xavier, so... Xavier, nice drive. I mean, you haven't really seen a lot of this offense getting going tonight, but this is definitely a positive sign for this Falcons team. Depending on the results of this game moving forward, maybe Beattie becomes their guy the rest of the season.
And Beattie gets in with the... Oh, no, the ball's on the ground.
Looks like a touchdown.
Is it a touchdown? Yes, they call it a touchdown.
We need a challenge on that. We need a challenge because I thought the
ball... Beattie crossed the plane before the ball hit the ground.
I don't even think the players know that the ball was... I don't even think the players know what's going on.
The 1 yard touchdown run for the Falcons.
That ball's on the ground. That ball was on the ground, Michael. I'm just saying. You saw that, right?
I did.
That ball was on the ground. Unless the whistle, he was already over the touchdown. Unless he was over it, okay. But it looked like that ball was out before anything was said and done.
Nonetheless, they don't challenge plays here in high school football, so Clark Beattie gets the touchdown, and we'll try to add on to it with the extra point. Snap is good. Kick is up. And 7 points for Clark Beattie on that drive. North Haven leads this one 42-21. You're watching Friday Night Football on NHTV.
Arnold's Jewelers, the North Haven Diamond Center, 117 Washington Avenue in North Haven. Decades of experience and a deep commitment to the North Haven community. Visit us today at thearnoldsjewelers.net.
North Haven Funeral Home, 36 Washington Avenue, North Haven. Since 1953, the one source families rely on for caring, compassionate service. North Haven Funeral Home.
So coming off the touchdown by Clark Beattie, let's look at this replay again, because Trevor pointed out this ball might have come out.
I'm just saying, if you really look at it, watch that ball come out. I don't know if he's over the right there, but that ball's on the ground. And it just stood there for quite a bit, and nobody picked it up. So unless the ref called it before that ball came out, okay. But just pointed it out.
It's hard from the camera angle that we have. Yeah, and obviously, we don't have the 25 cameras the NFL has.
Yeah, right.
So it's tough because it looks like Pringle is pushing Beattie in.
Yes.
As the onside kick goes to no avail there. But to me, it looks like, if we can see the replay one more time before this drive starts, to me, it looks like Pringle pushed Beattie into the end zone. And as he's doing that, that's when the ball pops. So the question is, did the nose of the ball go over the line?
That's what I'm saying.
As the ball's popped out.
But the way he was running up forward where the ball doesn't look like he put the ball over. All I'm saying is that everybody was standing around, and that ball was there for quite some time. I was just a bit surprised. It's a touchdown in the stat sheet, but it's something that I would have.
McCormick gets the carry and goes all the way to the 48-yard line, close to the first down marker, to see where it's marked. He'll be about a yard short, so a 9-yard carry for the freshman there. Second and one. Clock continues to run, which is in North Haven's favor, up 3 touchdowns. Xavier has all 3 timeouts. North Haven also with all 3 of their timeouts if they need them at any point.
I expect North Haven to continue to just run the ball unless Xavier can find a way to get in that backfield, get aggressive, strip the ball or something. It's going to be a tough, like I said, right? Just but what you're seeing, DeMoro's had a heck of a game overall. And
the ball comes out and it goes right into the hands of a Xavier player.
Covered by the Falcons.
I don't know if that was a reverse.
Wait, so what the heck just happened? What's going on here? The past couple plays are bananas. It's going bananas over here.
Let's see what happened here.
So they don't call.
The ball comes out. The ball definitely comes out on that one.
They call a fumble.
I think Tyler DeMoro was looking for forward progress to stop. On the last drive, there was a play.
That's what I was
Was it Brandon Stevens where he kept moving and moving? And
yes.
His forward progress did not stop, and they called forward progress stop. This time, it looked like forward progress was stopped. They keep the play going.
And then the goal line play on top of it. This has been a wild game, to say the least.
So a non-fumble call, a non-forward progress call, and Xavier could find the way back into this game. Beattie tries to throw this one deep, up the middle and complete for the first down, cross the 40-yard line, and they're in North Haven territory quickly.
And right now, Beattie is delivering. He's got the pocket presence there, staying in there, delivering another bullet to his receiver. I mean, he's been very impressive for the short sample size we've seen in this game.
So first and 10. Whistle blown. I don't know. Was there
an official timeout?
The chains
look like they're a little off. One of the refs is fixing it. The side judge in the corner on Xavier's side is fixing the chain. So that's the issue as we speak. And we're good now.
This could be a giant momentum swing if Xavier could get into the end zone on this drive and make this a 2-score game.
And how fast can they score, though? If they're going to slow up tempo it, then it's not going to be good. But if you can pick up a score within the next minute or so, you have a ball game.
Beattie evades a sack, throws it out of bounds, and makes it incomplete. But a great pressure there by Luke Asbury and Brian Moran on that play. given no time for Beattie to set the pass play.
But you'll take that. If you're Xavier's coaching staff, you'll take that any day. You live to fight another day. Throws the ball out of bounds. They get another opportunity. Beattie has been impressive. Like I just said, he's been impressive for what we've seen so far. Moving the ball, confident. It looks like this team is confident in Beattie carrying them and trying to get back into this game. So we'll see. I know it's a three-score game and there's under 10 minutes left, but there's a lot for what the way this game has been played out. A lot can go on from here on out.
Beattie drops back. Has to come out of the pocket. Trying to take it upon himself. Ball almost stripped out of his hands, and he's dropped at the 30-yard line. So making something out of nothing on that play as Beattie makes another great run, third and short.
Yeah, that's a credit to the secondary. No options available, so he just takes it with his legs, making the smart decision, and getting a first down for Xavier. So Xavier's moving the ball. Their confidence is right there for them.
It actually ended up being a first down. He got enough for the first down, so that moved the chains. So first and 10 from the 29-yard line. Beattie looks left, throws towards the end zone, and it is incomplete. Intended to Oli Obi.
I mean, he's going to take the shots like that. He's got a strong arm. You saw in the first drive he came in. He's got the arm to do it. He's going to take shots. If it's there, he's going to do it. He's going to pull the trigger. Right there, he tried to. Just a little overthrown, but got to give. I mean, if you're the coaching staff of Xavier, got to be liking what you're seeing from Beattie early on or late in this game right now.
9:16 to go in the game. Beattie. Thrown, pass is complete to Obi, and he's got the first down.
Oli Obi will be reception and the first down for the Falcons.
I mean, they're getting pressure on him, Michael. He right there, he was almost going to go down for a sack, but a great job of the body strength to stay up and still deliver the ball to your weapon. And Beattie, again, another first down for the Falcons.
It makes you wonder if Beattie should have started this game.
It does. Unless Andrea got hurt or something. That's what.
Pass is complete.
Looks like it's complete.
That one's a Kastner inside the five. So Xavier gets another first and goal situation as Beattie just continues to move this Xavier team downfield.
Yeah, he's just moving the ball with confidence, it just seems like. And right there, one of the cardinal sins for any quarterback is to never throw across the body. He did that. Got a little lucky right there, but he'll take it. I mean, he's got command, total command of this offense. And like we were just saying, like Michael just said, it begs to ask the question: what if he starts this game right now? Do they have the movement they've had so far? Like they've had the past two drives.
Beattie stopped just before the goal line, gets a couple yards on that play, and you know, going back to that pass, Mastriani looked like he could have had the interception there.
Right there, just great job of his receiver to come back for the ball and make the play.
Second down and goal from the 4. Someone had to tie their shoe before the snap was made.
Who's got to tie your shoes? You don't want to trip and hurt yourself.
So here's the second down. Beattie fakes the handoff. Throws incomplete.
Beattie's pass.
Intended for Omi.
That might have been the worst play from Beattie tonight because he has him. He has him wide open. Just got to deliver to him a little out route right there and just overthrows him by a couple inches. But I'm actually also surprised from what I saw is I'm surprised he didn't run it in right there. Because
yeah, he had the
room. He's been just as effective, not just with his arms, but as effective with the legs too. So I'm surprised he didn't just, and he's a bigger guy, so I'm surprised he didn't just try to bully his way in if he could have.
And that would have been less time off the clock if he takes it upon himself. Now they have a whole other play that they got to make here.
Yep.
Third and one. Beattie hands it off to Pringle, and he's going to be stopped.
And Ian Pringle is stopped short of the goal line.
Wow, what I mean, that's a beautiful play by North Haven right there. You're at the 1 yard line. Pringle's had some success. I won't say a lot tonight, but at times he's had success of making just basic runs for him that turned into massive runs for this team. But a great job by North Haven, and here we go. Pretty much the ball game, Michael.
Fourth and one from the one. Timeout, Xavier. We'll take a timeout here. You're watching Friday Night Football on NHTV.
The Rotary Club of North Haven, where the business community comes together. For personal growth and leadership development, Rotary makes one a better community citizen. For more information, please visit nhrotary.org today.
Arnold's Jewelers, the North Haven Diamond Center, 117 Washington Avenue in North Haven. Decades of experience and a deep commitment to the North Haven community. Visit us today at thearnoldsjewelers.net.
Fourth and goal. Beattie goes under center. Man in motion. Fake the handoff.
Flag on the play.
And a flag on the play.
It looks like illegal procedure against the Falcons.
So that's going to go against Xavier. So instead of it being close to the goal line where you need just 1 yard, you now go back to the six.
Oh, you're hating that right now if you're Xavier. You really have had – you're just so excited to see what they've done the past two drives, moving the ball and being able to put in the end zone last drive and near – and right near of putting it in again, and now a big penalty. So now – to answer your question, now it's a pass play. Now you look to pass, I would say. But keep an eye on where 16 goes because he has been able to move and extend plays in this drive.
Fourth and goal. Beattie looks to pass. Has a man. Pringle reaches for it. Is he in? No, he's not. The knee was down before it crossed the plane. Turnover on downs.
That's a great call. Looks like he has him. He tries to. I wish we had the camera view for this, but if you watch his knee, that's a great play. His knee is down before the ball is over, before the goal line. So a huge, huge stop for North Haven and a backbreaker for the Falcons offense.
Artie McCormick saves them another touchdown. Two times tonight, he saved North Haven from a touchdown.
Yes, he has. So now North Haven inside at the 1 yard line. I expect them to just run the ball, run their way to try to win their fifth game in a much, much needed win. But that's just a great job by North Haven's defense. They've played great throughout this game, with the exception of a few drives. They've looked great, getting after the quarterback, turnovers, and now a goal line stand, a huge, huge positivity for this defense who has had their moments throughout this season. It's got to feel good for this defense and Coach Filardi.
Pastriani gets the first down carry for 3 yards. Clock continues to run under 7 minutes. And a huge win for North Haven, ending the winning streak of Xavier if they can hold on here with 6:37 to go as they go on the road next week to Fairfield Prep.
Pastriani on the carry.
Gets to the 10-yard line.
Gets out to about the 10-yard line. It's going to be third and about a yard.
Third and short. As Coach Sags is giving the play to, well, it looked like he was going to give it to McCormick, but he's like,
no, McCormick, you. They might call, it looks like Coach Sags might call timeout.
Just kill the clock now.
As of right now, you're at the 6 minute mark. Might as well, you're fourth and one. Honestly, even though they're inside their own 20, fourth and one, if they do not get it, I'm going for it. I know it sounds crazy because you're in your own territory right now, but. Fourth and one, I'm going for it if they get to that situation.
Third and one from the 10. Direct snap to Mastriani. He's got the first down, and that moves the chains and will keep the clock moving.
First down.
It doesn't have to be pretty. As long as they can get the first down and chip away at that clock, that's what they're going to do. And right now, Xavier has no answers, as it looks like this is actually North Haven. They are currently on a four-game winning streak in this series, trying to go five straight since 2017. So,
and the last
little history fact.
The last time North Haven and Xavier met, where Xavier won that game, it was led by some quarterback named Will Levis.
The mayo, the mayonnaise guy. That's what they call him, the mayonnaise guy. Yeah, Will Levis. Think about that. 6-8 years ago, playing against North Haven.
Yep.
Now he's playing on Sundays for the Tennessee Titans, so... And that game was 50-49.
That was a, yeah.
That was eight years ago. But Xavier's been known as a well-respected program for years. And for North Haven to have wins like this, it's always a confidence, a program builder. It's always nice to get wins like this.
Run goes to the outside. McCormick breaks one tackle, has open field, and cuts and brought down at the 30-yard line. So that's another North Haven first down.
I mean, that's a great job. But 33 misses the block. Just McCormick keep moving the feet and just being the playmaker that he is right there. Could have been a lot bigger if 33 holds onto that block on the edge and sets the edge for him. But just Artie McCormick doing Artie McCormick things. So I'm not surprised by what he's been able to do. And his impact in general, it doesn't have to be for him going 300 yards to be like, oh, you always need to know where 22 is on the field. He's got that reputation for North Haven, and it just showed with that last play, too.
Carry past the 35-yard line by Tyler DeMauro, who's had himself an impressive game tonight. Did lose a fumble. That was a very crazy lost fumble. But nonetheless, he's had himself, I got to check the stat sheet, but he's close to 100 yards, I would think, with the amount of volume he's had in two touchdowns tonight.
He's got the 57-yard touchdown, you said it was.
Yep.
Then he has another touchdown, but he's also been heavily involved in the game plan, not just those two runs, but he's, I don't know how many carries he's had tonight, but he's been heavily involved in this offensive game plan.
Ball shot at the 38-yard line, it'll be a second and three.
Second and three from the 38-yard line. Direct snap.
Mastriani
who goes really nowhere on that play. So it'll be third and three.
If North Haven can get another first down, you can pretty much just continue to run the football right here. But with 3 minutes left, North Haven going to go to 5-3. A much needed win here, especially coming off of last week's disappointing loss to West Haven.
An injury timeout on the field.
Injury timeout. 2:56 to go in this game. You're watching Friday Night Football on NHTV.
North Haven Funeral Home, 36 Washington Avenue, North Haven. Since 1953, the one source families rely on for caring, compassionate service. North Haven Funeral Home.
Club of North Haven, where the business community comes together. For personal growth and leadership development, Rotary makes one a better community citizen. For more information, please visit nhrotary.org today.
Coming out of the break here, 2:56 to go. 42-21 the score here. Trevor, you got any scores for us here?
We're just getting some scores right now. Hand won 25-0 over Notre Dame. Shelton lost again. And what was the other one? We had another one you just gave me? Hamden? Say Hamden was losing too?
Hamden was losing 42-9. 42-9
Hamden was losing. So we got some scores going on. We're trying to do it all over here.
Mastriani gets the first down. And dropped at the 45-yard line. So that should be it here at Mike Vanacore Field as North Haven can just eat out the rest of the clock and let Xavier burn those final two timeouts if they choose to do so.
So, yes, Cheshire beat Shelton 10-3. I'm just looking through some scores right now for us. Prep won 42-9 over Hamden. That's who they play next week.
So both that one could be a shootout, it looks like. Both teams could ride up the score. And Fairfield Prep, having themselves a great year, now move to 7-1 on the year. Their only loss against the number one Class M team in Madison, or excuse me, Daniel Hand Madison.
And Madison is a good team. Madison is very solid. So, yeah, North Haven does their job. They came in, especially with the way they played last week. And people will see that score last week and say 32-7. But if they were here, they saw North Haven was in that game, 1-for-6 from the red zone, didn't capitalize on. But coming back tonight after the tough defeat last week, coming back and getting back to just basic football, getting back to running the football, getting back to your bread and butter. Defensively, making plays in the secondary, making plays, getting to the quarterback. And then special teams as well. I mean, it's been all phases of the game that has worked for North Haven tonight. And it's a very solid, solid win, and a much-needed win as well, Michael.
Mastriani gets another first down run there as he crosses it to the 45-yard line into Xavier territory. So at this point, it could be victory formation. As North Haven will prepare for their final road game of the year in a must-win situation against a very, very tough matchup at Fairfield Prep.
Against the Jesuits.
Who they've had their struggles with that team, especially on the road. So will we
become... It's a tough place. It's a tough place to play at.
Do they come into Thanksgiving against Shelton? Do they come into that Thanksgiving game against Shelton with a win and you're in situation?
Time will tell, my friend. But all we know is they get a win in tonight's calendar. And that's all that matters. They get back to the winning ways, 5-3. Good things that they can build off of and get ready for next week in a huge, huge game up in, or down in Fairfield Prep.
And they kneel it one last time. So North Haven will close it out with the victory, 42-21. They bounce back after a tough loss against West Haven. They come back and win this one and improve to 5-3 with two games left, one on the road and one at home. Let's keep it here. Let's go to the highlights as we, I mean, that is... eventful, but it started off big. 57 yards to the house. Tyler DeMoro, you know, gives it North Haven the huge lead. Then this botched snap from Clark to Clark Beattie keeps North Haven into the 3-yard line and leads to the touchdown run. Tyler DeMoro, his second touchdown of the night, second and a half. Sam Andreas throws this one up the middle, but it's intercepted. His second interception, and that was the last we saw from Sam Andrea for the night. Then there was this beautiful pass here to Brandon Stevens. Keep it on his feet, keep it on his feet. They stopped forward progress on that play. Then we see Craig Beattie come into this game. Beautifully throw a ball to Michael Waters. But go all the way here. Go all the way. And gets the touchdown. Might have been a fumble, but they don't call it. Forward progress could have been called here, but they don't call it, and it's a fumble. Turnover on Xavier. They move it all the way to eventually a controversial fourth down, and North Haven stops them, and that leads us to where we are. Final score, 42-21. Trevor, your closing thoughts on this one as you get your headset fixed there.
I'm sorry.
You got it?
Yeah, I'm good. I'm good to go. So what I just said, pretty much, I'm very impressed just overall from North Haven's play tonight. We're getting back to the basics. That's what they needed to do. Sometimes just got to get back to basics and just do what you do best. Running the football, keeping the clock, keeping the tempo in your favor, keeping the offense on the field, and not being able to, you know, have situations like last week where you've had that you're moving the ball but never capitalized. Tonight was a different story. Defensively, great job. I mean, Brandon Stevens was tremendous all around the field, whether it was receiving, whether it was special teams or the pick six. And DeMoro, I mean, just very impressive because we've always talked about Mastriani, McCormick this entire season, but DeMoro, it was his game today. It was that type of game and just a job well done on all facets of the game and a much-needed win for this North Haven team and get themselves prepared for a very, very tough opponent next week against the Jesuits.
They're going to need their weapons next week against Fairfield Prep. But the next time you'll see us here on North Haven Television will be Thanksgiving morning.
I'm looking forward to
against
it, man.
Shelton in a one-off Thanksgiving game.
The first time in 5 years, man. We're back in Thanksgiving. It'll be fun.
Yes, it will be.
For Don't everyone, be too excited now, Michael.
For everyone here at North Haven Television, Trevor Keyes, my name is Michael Valenti, saying so long from Mike Vanacore Field. Again, the final score, 42-21.